The Bud Light Countdown is on. Arkansas football begins in 86 days.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Broadcasting live from the Bud Light Studio.
You're causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
HitThatLine.com.
There's a lot of lions, tigers, and bears, but they ain't but one Razorback. Number one.
This is The Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
Sunshine.
That's cool. I can dig.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
I was watching Californication yesterday before the MLB draft, and I was thinking I'll wait 20 or so minutes heading into this because Heston's probably not going to be drafted until like the 7, 8, 9, 10 mark. So my roommate comes back from his job and he's like, hey, can we flip on the MLB draft? And I was like, all right, that's fine. I mean, I'll wait a little bit. We'll see some of these names, some guys that I've heard of that have played in the SEC that will get drafted, other guys that I had no idea who they were. And then, out of the blue, the second pick, as Rob Manfred gets up to the podium and says Heston Kjerstad has been drafted. Regardless of what MLB draft site you look at, who you listen to as far as MLB analysts are, the college analysts, no one, and I mean no one, had Heston going number two except the Baltimore Orioles and that organization. And after that happened, after he was drafted, not only did you see the excitement from his family and friends in his draft room, in his house or apartment or whatever, then just it exploded on Twitter from Razorback fans. And it comes back to one person, Dave Van Horn. Dave Van Horn, consistent, tried and true, and you're so happy to have him as the head baseball coach at the University of Arkansas. This is The Morning Rush. He's Tommy Kraft. I'm Ty Richardson. 877-377-6963 is the number to call or text. And we're all streaming live on HitThatLine.com. You can find our video stream on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. If you have a smart speaker, just say play ESPN Arkansas. We're also on the TuneIn app as well. We'll get Tom Murphy's reaction about Heston getting drafted number two overall coming up at 7:15, and then talk recruiting with Richard Davenport on a Recruiting Thursday, which is brought to you by Breeden RV. Things are really heating up right now at Breeden RV, and it's time for their annual trade-up event going on through June the 30th. Trade up and get $5,000. Yes, $5,000 over NADA trade-in value. Trade up and take advantage of rock-bottom prices on all new, used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. You can trade up and get free maintenance for life on everything new. Breeden RV will also take care of your service needs on all makes and models. Shop today right now online at BreedenRV.com and then come see Ransom in the Game between Van Buren and Alma on Alma Highway. That's Breeden RV, where adventures begin. Did you watch it last night?
I was not watching. I'm like you. I mean, didn't expect him to be taken that early. I guess if we had listened to maybe some clues Dave Van Horn was given a day or two ago, we might have realized he could have gone ahead of what we thought. But no, I mean, I got the news on Twitter just like the rest of it. And Laura says, you going to watch any more of the draft? I'm like, not really a reason to for me now. The guy I wanted to watch is already gone. So, I mean, quick work of it. But what a great surprise and a great uplift for Razorback fans, but certainly for Heston Kjerstad first and foremost. My thought, and we were kind of texting, the three of us and Phil and guys here at the station, the shortened season helped him. I mean, because how can you go in? I mean, obviously you go number one, but I mean, he went higher than expected. The risk of playing more season, the risk of injury, the risk of the shortened season, how can you say anything other than this, the time he had in that month and everything he's done in the previous seasons, everything he's done in summer leagues, everything he's done and all the, you know, he lived on that and it was enough. And, anything of a longer season, I'm of the belief, I have nothing to back it up, just an opinion, if he'd have played a full season, might not have been drafted. Probably wouldn't have been drafted that high.
Batted over 400, had a 16-game hitting streak. I mean, really just showed out at the beginning of the season. The only thing that, as Arkansas fans, unfortunately, is you didn't get to see him in postseason this year. That was the thing you wanted. He talked about last night, and we'll get in some audio coming up. The teams that were on back-to-back College World Series, which has never been done in the history of Razorback baseball. Well, this team, I know they started out, they didn't start out great. They went down to Houston, and lost those three games against Oklahoma, Texas, and forgetting the other team in that series. But there was an impression, like there is under
Missouri.
I don't remember.
Yeah, it was Missouri.
There was an impression that, as there is often with Dave Van Horn teams, that they would figure out and potentially get back to another College World Series. Unfortunately, even though the shortened season helped them, we as Razorback fans did not see what could have been the end to a great career for Heston Kjerstad.
And he was definitely going to be one of the leaders on the team. There's no guarantee this team was going to make even a super regional. I think they were a regional team. The way this team played left you with a lot of question marks about what kind of postseason they were going to have. But nonetheless, what he did in the month or so of baseball they had was enough to turn heads.
It was Baylor. That was the other team we forgot.
Baylor,
it was three. I know it's like
three Big 12 teams. Three. Missouri was the other SEC team. But
so for those who didn't
LSU,
hear,
Arkansas, Missouri.
For those who didn't hear what Heston's draft call sounded like last night, here's Rob Manfred when he got up to the podium.
With the second pick of the 2020 MLB draft, the Baltimore Orioles select Heston Kjerstad, an outfielder from the University of Arkansas.
So Manfred got his name right, but Baltimore's SID on the Zoom call did not last night. Yeah. He said Heston Kjerstad or something. Yeah. He said it wrong. I just laughed at that because as a commissioner, whether it's Adam Silver, whether it's Roger Goodell, whether it's Rob Manfred, their job is hard enough in itself on their day-to-day business activities. But with the addition of, oh, by the way, now you have to memorize however many names heading up to the MLB draft. Luckily, because we've had I don't think it was Manfred, but I don't remember if it was Bud Selig, but you remember how bad they butchered Andrew Benintendi's name?
Yeah, I remember
it
that.
It was like Andrew Benintendi, like they just absolutely.
Well, that wasn't
like,
that many years ago.
It was
2015.
2015. And you're sitting up there, and you're an Arkansas guy. You're sitting up there, it's like, come on. Like, this guy just got drafted seventh overall, and you're just like, man, they just butchered his name. Bad. But Manfred got it, and the Baltimore Orioles, they got a player.
The check will still cash. So, I mean, I guess Kjerstad can.
His check's going to be a big one, too.
He can still live with it. But great night last night. And I'm going to tell you, this is a great night for Dave Van Horn for recruiting because this was a flex move when this was over.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you talk about signaling to every recruit, the ones you've signed upcoming and the ones down the road. Also to the guys on your team about thinking about, you know, should I stay or go to a Casey Opitz kind of guy? Not that Opitz would ever go number two, but just the point that we've always talked about. What do these guys want to do? They want to play in the pros. They want to get paid to play baseball for most of their 20s, maybe into their 30s. Coming to Arkansas will lift your value. Clearly, Dave Van Horn and this program have the trust of Major League Baseball franchises because they continually keep taking players in the first, second, third round. And another selection in the first round and the second highest overall, Jeff King went number one overall back in 1986. So second highest drafted. I think McReynolds was sixth or seventh overall, and then kind of keep going down the list from there. But second highest ever drafted. Benintendi was seventh, and McReynolds was sixth.
Yep.
So you just keep going down the list. Second highest ever drafted Razorback in program history.
And the ninth Razorback ever to be drafted in the first round, the sixth over under Dave Van Horn. So it just shows you the track record of success that Dave Van Horn has had. And here's another statistic that should blow your mind, and we'll bring it up later in the program. Heston Kjerstad, when he was drafted out of high school, he was drafted in the 36th round to the Seattle Mariners. Since then, he has risen 35 rounds and 1,083 draft picks. Let's put that in perspective. Uh-huh. 35 rounds and over 1,000 draft picks. Now, Dave Van Horn can't sit in every living room with the high school kid who's on the brink of, hey, I'm just going to go straight to the MLB out of college, or out of high school, excuse me. But this is, as you mentioned, a magnificent recruiting tool. look what I did for Heston Kjerstad. This was a guy that was drafted in the 36th round. I got him to the number 2 overall pick. What a recruiting tool for Dave Van Horn. 877-377-6963 is the number 2 call or text in. Coming up, we'll get into some quickie headlines here on the Morning Rush. Stay with us.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
If you have experience transporting frozen and refrigerated goods and want to be part of a trucking family with insurance and be home every week, you need to contact Brent Higgins Trucking. Since 1997, Brent Higgins Trucking in Mulberry has been proudly delivering to and from various areas of the United States, including but not limited to Oklahoma, Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi. Brent Higgins Trucking, where you're a name, not a number. Contact them at 479-997-2366 or at BrentHigginsTrucking.com.
Spring is here and there's no better time to get out of the house and back on the road. Time for the windows rolled down and the radios turned up. Southern Tire Mart proudly offers America's most trusted brands such as Toyo. Trust us for your last minute getaways, open road adventures, and memories that outlast the drive. When you can rely on your tires, you are free to enjoy the ride. Your Toyo tires are waiting for you at Southern Tire Mart, just off I-540 at exit 14 in Fort Smith. Southern Tire Mart and Toyo, we keep you rolling.
Hey, this is Ted with Ed Walker's Drive-In. For more than 70 years, Ed Walker's has been the place to go for the best French dips and hand-patted hamburgers in town. Blue Plate Specials served Monday through Friday, and we're still the home of Fort Smith's only 5-pound hamburger. We're open 10 a.m. to midnight, 7 days a week. Call ahead for pickup, 783-3352. Ed Walker's Drive-In, 1500 Towson Avenue in Fort Smith, where the legend lives on.
Are you looking for a new place to call home? Whether you're looking for an apartment, duplex, townhome, or a house, Trinity Multifamily has you covered. They even have options in surrounding states, from Texas to Michigan and Kansas to Tennessee. If you're looking for a new place to call home, make Trinity Multifamily your first call at 479-452-1817. That's 479-452-1817. Or online at trinitymultifamily.com to search rental properties near you.
Locally owned Lumber One can handle all of your building needs. They've built their business on having great relationships with everybody from contractors and builders to the everyday build-it-yourself. Lumber One is a full-line door shop to handle all of your door, window, and trim needs. And along with lumber, roofing and drywall products, attic wall and floor insulation is available. Lumber One also does blueprint takeoff with access to design services with estimates available. So go where the pros go. Lumber One, located on Industrial Park Road in Van Buren.
In sports, success is measured in points, wins, and trophies. At Shelter Insurance, we measure success in the quality of our products and services, in our community support, in being there when you need us, and the occasional trophy, like the one from J.D. Power for highest customer satisfaction among auto insurers in the Central Region. For J.D. Power 2019 award information, visit jdpower.com/awards.
Ask Shelter agents Brandon Zimmerman or Chris Dooley about a free insurance review.
Tri-Hill Turf offers the highest quality turf and pest services. Hey, you say those are big words. Well, let's see. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has a company agronomist, state and nationally certified technicians, free soil testing, and they even have precision GPS guided application equipment. Now that's high tech. For over 30 years, Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has used the latest application technology, and they strive for turf and pest excellence. They are your local turf and pest experts. Call the local team at 782-0404. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest.
Trade Pros. Ferguson is committed to making business with us the easiest part of your day. Ferguson.com is designed to help run your business from the office to the job site by making your day-to-day activities easier with 24/7 account access, unmatched online inventory, and on-the-go account management. And with our Pro Plus customer loyalty program, you can earn points with every online purchase, redeemable for merchandise, event tickets, trips, and more. Sign up today at Ferguson.com.
Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
ESPN 95.3.
Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
We're streaking! Come on! We're live! Come on! Woo! We're streaking!
I'm going to try this call-in number.
Call or text the Morning Rush at 877-377-6963.
My first official call-in.
Welcome back into the Morning Rush. Going to get in some quick inning headlines here coming up. And there's a bunch of them, so we'll do that. SEC Media Days. I know that's a big deal for all of you guys listening and gals because of the information. And I say that kind of with air quotes around that, the information that comes out of SEC Media Days. There's some stuff that comes out, but that is now going to a virtual format. Chuck Dunlap, who does SEC Communications, sent out an email about that yesterday, and it's going to be in a virtual format. Big 12, Mountain West, and MAC have already announced that they're going to do virtual as well, but that was big news coming out of the Southeastern Conference yesterday.
So how bummed were you? I know you were
saddened.
I was
very saddened because I have a karaoke and White Claw game down there, and now I don't get to redeem myself from that pitiful performance last year from Sugar We're Going Down Swinging.
So just to let the audience kind of understand what this event means to you. This is your Augusta National every year. This is the event every year you think you were built for.
I thrive there.
You've got a broad, loose interpretation of the definition of the word thrive, but this is the event you center your calendar around.
What is the what is the story I heard yesterday of you wearing a Natty Light Hawaiian shirt and you being the brunt of the SEC Media Days?
Well, so Barrett Salee, who writes for CBS Sports, formerly of Bleacher Report, for a longest time, him and buddies and a mix of crew have gone to this karaoke bar on Wednesday night down in Hoover, Alabama. I'm forgetting the name, but it's quite fun. It's quite entertaining, and I had the luxury of being invited this past season. So got to go, had a great time, drank a lot of seltzers, and it was a blast. But the singing aspect, I did not thrive there. I will admit that's why I wanted to redeem
myself. What happened to the rule? We don't drink during the week before the show. What happened to that rule?
Well, the SEC Media Days is a holiday, so it does not apply to that. So,
did you work while you were there?
Oh, yeah. I was putting in 15-hour days because that's what I do.
Yeah.
So you get paid double time since it's a holiday? Is that how it works?
No, Tommy's not that that type of boss. He just expects me do that, but it was fun. I was disappointed seeing the news yesterday. Several of my friends
18-hour days, but you know,
several of my friends reached out and were bummed as well that go down as media members. But you know what, live and you learn. It's whatever, it happens. Got to adjust as is.
As far as virtual format, we saw this coming. I mean, we had already been planning here internally that we're not going. Mm-hmm. You know, so hey, now we don't have to spend that $1,000 for the internet line to be run over to our table.
Yeah.
I think it's actually like $1,200 last year.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah. They charge you for a power cord. It's just
a little
ridiculous. I think it's to get a table and the setup and the internet and all, it's like $1,500. But we do it because we want to be there because, you know, he wants to go to White Claw night. So.
Oh, yeah, because you guys didn't go to Media Days before I got here. Y'all didn't go for many years?
Oh, I've been to like, I haven't been the last two or three, but I've been to 13 straight or whatever. You got a ways to go to catch up with me, Sonny boy.
Yeah, got the NCAA down there. It was a good old time. We were the talk of it. Jordan Rogers was talking about my hair, saying I had the best flow down
there.
See,
now you're just making things up.
Literally, he said best hair.
You believe that?
Okay, I'll show you the tweet. You guys want to lie about that, that's fine.
What were you saying during the break? You got real defensive talking about?
Anytime you call him out on something, he starts getting really defensive.
Yeah, because I don't like being called a liar. I like being called a truther, because that's what I am.
A truther?
Yeah.
A truther.
I speak truth.
Listen, a truther.
You may not like you may not like something I say, but you can always tell it's going to be honest. And I'm not kidding. Jordan said I had top shelf lettuce and that I had the best hair at SEC Media Days. So I'm not joking about that. Cross my heart.
Mark him down the list on my analyst. Now I believe him less.
Cross my heart. All right. So Dave Van Horn is already scheduled out.
Jordan Rogers also said Chad Morris was going to be a good coach in Arkansas.
You know what?
Take that for what it's worth.
If you want to use that against him, that's fine. I'm pretty sure at one point in time he did say that. Arkansas, we've talked about that the policy has changed as of last Friday. You can play A-State, you can play UCA outside of football. Dave Van Horn's already made do with all that going on. He's got UAPB and UALR already scheduled prior to that. Then he scheduled ASU and UCA. Well, Mike Nabors has also done that. The Razorbacks are going to play Euler and North Little Rock. That was already scheduled. And then they're also going to play Arkansas State, UCA, and Arkansas Pine Bluff the following season. So this is going to be something that the women's basketball coach, Mike Nabors, is taking advantage of. Dave Van Horn, head baseball coach, is taking advantage of. Be curious to see how the other sports coaches up in Fayetteville react to the policy change that was set forth on Friday.
And, you know, I don't think Arkansas fans are going to attend a baseball game in Little Rock anymore. They already packed the park out, whether they're playing UCA or Arkansas State or UAPB or somebody. The basketball arena, I think, would be full regardless. I mean, and I say full, relatively full, but they haven't been quite filling that building up because it didn't hold quite the number Bud Walton does. It's like 16,000. You're a Little Rock guy.
You're talking about Simmons Bank?
Simmons Bank, okay. Yeah. It's just slightly smaller than Bud Walton, mm-hmm. but historically in the last 5 years, they haven't filled that thing up. But last year was fairly full. And I think next year, regardless of opponent, it would be full anyway. So I don't think that just because you're playing an in-state school is going to bring this massive turnout where tickets are being scalped outside the door. But I think fans will be interested.
Who is John Brady still not at ASU? Who's there? Jenkins, will you look up who?
John Brady's doing radio for LSU.
Okay. Who is? Look up who ASU's basketball coach is. Because Arkansas State. I can't think of who that is. But they're going to play. They're actually going to travel to Jonesboro in 2021 and 2022, the women's basketball team. So I'm curious to see if the Arkansas men's basketball team and Anthony Ruta, who heads that up that schedule, if he'll be putting Arkansas, if him and Muss and everyone else to come to agreement, well, they'll play Arkansas State, UCA, the other teams as well.
Hey, hang
a
on.
Lot.
My bad.
Name is Mike Bellotto.
Sounds like you nailed it.
I think you got
good
it.
Enough for me.
So, but this is interesting because the Arkansas women haven't played a regular season in-state game since 1983. Well, good stat from Whole Hog Sports.
And this is all great and fine. But until you schedule football, are you really excited about any of this until football is scheduled?
I would be excited to see Arkansas and Arkansas State play basketball in Little Rock. I think now it doesn't have the draw to football, but you're just talking about that you haven't sold out Simmons Bank Arena, what I always refer to as Altel. I'll always know it as Altel.
Yep.
That would sell out. If you had Arkansas playing Arkansas State in a non-conference matchup around Christmas time, which is how they usually do it, you wouldn't be able to get a seat. That would sell out, I guarantee it.
So, I mean, I think you're right, assuming some things return closer to normal. But, yeah, I think the interest will be there. My point is they were still going to have 14,000, 15,000 in the building, regardless, just because there's heat and excitement around this basketball program in its mm-hmm. current state.
I'm wondering if it would be elevated if they got to that point. But I'm curious to see what Eric Musselman, we've seen what Mike Nabors has done. We've seen what Dave Van Horn has done. Is Eric Musselman the next guy to go down that list? Unfortunately, for the SEC baseball, the SEC tried to get it up to 13.7 scholarships. It got denied. It's still at 11.7. So once again,
two more scholarships.
Yeah, once again, the SEC trying to lead the charge as far as getting something passed with baseball. It's not happening, unfortunately.
Clearly, other Power 5 conferences just don't want to invest in baseball the way the SEC does. I think this will further lead the charge for the Power 5 leagues maybe to break away at some point.
Mm-hmm. So. Division 1 committee, one more on this. The 35 roster cap has been lifted for this upcoming year because of everything going on with COVID and the fact that they discontinued this past season. So that is not going to apply. That has actually happened, according to Kendall Rogers. 877-377-6963, the number to call or text in. We're going to talk more Heston Kjerstad coming up. His thoughts on being drafted second overall. Stay with us.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
The Arkansas Scholarship Lottery has some much-needed good news to share. Every day, we're creating winning futures with lottery scholarships and winning moments for players from all over the natural state. We thank our players and we congratulate our scholars for helping us keep that winning feeling, even in these challenging times. The lottery is here for students today and will be when it's time for school. Apply for a lottery scholarship today at scholarships.adhe.edu. This is winning.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC has over 200 pre-owned vehicles to choose from luxury to economy and everything in between, including over 50 great vehicles with payments under $250 a month, certain to fit your needs and your budget. And at Harry Robinson Buick GMC, you always get more for your trade. 50 vehicles with payments under $250 a month at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off I-540 in Fort Smith.
Doe's Eat Place is now open to serve you the award-winning steaks you've been missing, along with your choice of drinks from the largest selection of wines, beer, and liquor in the River Valley. Doe's Eat Place is open Tuesday through Thursday, 5 till 9, and Friday and Saturday, 5 till 10. Doe's Eat Place welcomes their loyal diners back and new diners to experience the best steaks, atmosphere, and service in the River Valley. The patio is also open for your dining pleasure. Just call for reservations. Doe's Eat Place, 422 North 3rd Street, Fort Smith.
Evans Body Shop wants you to know that you are now able to get the repair process started on your schedule. With just a few clicks of your cell phone, you can send photos and your vehicle information directly to our shop. We will respond within 24 hours with a detailed estimate for repairs. It's that simple. We are here for you. Visit our website for all of the details. We offer complimentary pickup and drop-off as well, and extra steps are being taken to ensure your car is returned as good as new and completely sanitized.
Evans Body Shop, where we meet the nicest people by accident.
Is your home at least 10 years old and served by OG&E? OG&E is offering Arkansas customers a free weatherization program to increase your comfort and lower your bills. A trained crew will perform an energy audit at no cost to you, and if your home qualifies, our crews will install measures that will save you money. The services provided through this program are absolutely free to qualifying homes. If you could benefit from free home weatherization improvements, call OG&E at 1-800-272-9741. That's 1-800-272-9741.
Folks, we at Mosquito Joe understand how important your yard is. It's where some of your best memories are made with your family. It's where you play catch with your kids or grandkids. It's where you have your friends over for those backyard barbecues. You don't have to keep letting mosquitoes crash the party. There's a solution for that now. Mosquito Joe protects your yard so you can focus on what's important. Call Mosquito Joe today. Get your first service for just $39. 479-202-9960. That's 202-9960. Or visit Arkansas.mosquitojoe.com.
Hey, grounds guys.
Hey, what?
It's time to turn over my lawn maintenance to the professionals. My husband just hasn't had time to take care of our yard anymore, and I'm constantly on the go. But I don't want to leave my yard to just anybody. The grounds guys are a professional lawn care provider I know I can trust to keep my yard looking beautiful. They have different maintenance plans available to fit exactly what I need. For $100 off any annual maintenance plan, call the grounds guys today at 479-303-GUYS. That's 303-4897.
Elite Roofing is a locally owned roofing contractor. If you're building a new home or maybe need a new roof on your existing home, Elite Roofing can take care of you. Elite Roofing is known for their dependability and reliability. Just ask any of their satisfied customers. They are licensed and insured, and references are available upon request. If you need a roof, call your local roofing contractors. Elite Roofing, 478-8668. That's 478-8668. Elite Roofing, 478-8668.
It's time for the annual trade-up event at Breeden RV, going on through June 30th. Trade up and get up to $5,000 on NADA trade-in value. Take advantage of rock-bottom prices on all new and used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. Head to Breeden RV's trade-up event and get free maintenance for life on everything new. Breeden RV will also take care of your service needs on all makes and models. Shop today at BreedenRV.com, then come see Breeden RV between Van Buren and Alma on Alma Highway. Breeden RV, where adventures begin. See dealer for details.
ESPN 95.3.
The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
Don't mean to bust up the party or anything. My shift starts in a couple hours. Thought I'd go home and get a little sleep. Aren't you guys tired?
I'll go get all the sleep I need when I'm dead.
Streaming live at hitthatline.com.
Want to talk about Heston Kjerstad and what he had to say after being drafted second overall to the Baltimore Orioles last night. Also want to get into our TV Dad's Bracket coming up. Before we do that, it is a recruiting Thursday, and if you go over to Breeden RV right now, you can take advantage of their annual trade-up event. It's going on through June the 30th, so you only have through this month, so you got to get over there quick. Trade up and get up to $5,000 over NADA trade-in value. Take advantage of rock-bottom prices on new, used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. And you get free maintenance for life if you buy something new. Breed and RV will also take care of all your service needs on all makes and models. Just go online right now at breedandrv.com, then come see Ransom in the game between Van Buren and Alma on Alma Highway. That's Breed and RV, where adventures begin. So if you go to hitthatline.com right now, top of the page, there is a TV Dads button. And we are doing this TV Dads bracket, if you haven't heard about it yet. There are 16 dads listed from a bunch of really good TV shows. And we don't have them seated or anything. They're just kind of pitted against each other. But they are as follows. Andy Taylor from The Andy Griffith Show going up against Mike Brady of The Brady Bunch. Homer Simpson of The Simpsons taking on Coach Taylor from Friday Night Lights. Red Foreman taking on that 70s show, taking on Peter Griffin from Family Guy. Stephen Keaton from Family Ties taking on Danny Tanner from Full House. Carl Winslow from Family Matters taking on Ward Cleaver from Leave It to Beaver. Frank Costanza of Seinfeld versus Tim Taylor of Home Improvement. Uncle Phil of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air taking on Hal Wilkerson of Malcolm in the Middle. And then George Lopez of The George Lopez Show taking on Al Bundy with Married and Children. And all of it is presented by Southern Tire Mart.
Now, Southern Tire Mart is your place for quality Michelin and BF Goodrich tires and the best-in-class service. It's all at Southern Tire Mart, where you can get what you need, and oil changes start at $29.95. It's at Southern Tire Mart, 540 and exit 14, or see them online at stmtires.com. So who do you think of those dads, those TV dads, is receiving the most votes? Who do you think right now would be dominating their matchup more than anyone else?
I think Al Bundy is going to be pretty tough to beat. Now, my favorite is Red Foreman from That 70s Show. And there's a bunch, again, there's a bunch of really good ones on this list.
Right.
Some shows that I've watched more than others, but it's going to be I would be surprised if Al Bundy didn't make it to the championship or win it. That's my opinion on that.
When I looked at this early yesterday, Al Bundy was trailing George Lopez.
Oh, wow.
He's made a return. He's got a pretty good lead over George Lopez now. The biggest lead, though, is Andy Taylor over Mike Brady, which surprises me the size of this lead right now. And, I mean, because this is a dominating lead at this point. So, like 90% to 10%.
First round voting goes through next Monday. So, you have all until next week to vote on the first round, yeah. Which, again, the matchups, go to hitthatline.com. You'll see the TV Dads icon right next to our Gaston's Father's Day giveaway icon, which you can also enter in as well. Then the second round is going to end the 17th on that Wednesday, and then we'll announce the winner on next Friday, June the 19th, of who wins the TV Dads bracket. So you ask me, in my opinion, who is probably going to be pretty tough to beat. I said Al Bundy, Married with Children. Who are you going with?
I think Andy Taylor's going to be the one that's tough to beat, because that show has been shown. I mean, every generation listening, other than maybe my kids, has seen some. The Andy Griffith Show has just been on syndication forever. I mean, it was. I don't even think it was new when my dad was around. I mean, I guess it was when he was a kid, because it was in the 50s and 60s. But just because that show has been in syndication for 60 years and so many people have seen it, that's going to be hard to beat.
It's a really good show. And again, there's some great ones on this list. We threw in two animated ones in Homer Simpson and Peter Griffin, because I think those are two that all people also really enjoy. To me, you know what's really cool about this is, for those who have watched Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, do you remember this? Did you watch that show growing up? Okay,
I did.
Do you remember the scene where Will Smith is crying because, like, his father, and this is not the actor that plays his father in the show is not actually his real father, because
his uncle.
Yeah. Well, the guy that plays the father in the show is not his actual real father. I'm referring to the guy that came in for the couple episodes. So, in his real life, Will was not. He was raised by his mom and not raising a single father. And so, in the show, I've read this. He was supposed to brush it off, like when his dad left, like that was what the script said, that was what his line said. But then he gets really emotional and starts going off, not verbatim. What do you call it when they go off script? What's the improv? Yeah. He goes improv, and then
ad lib was what I was gonna say.
And then Uncle Philip grabs him, hugs him, and that's like one of the most emotional scenes of any TV show, because it was real. Because yeah. Will F. Smith actually didn't have a father growing up, and so it was really cool to see how Uncle Phil reacted to that in the show. But really, a great list of TV dads. Again, go to hitthatline.com. It's on the button. It's at the top of the page. It just says TV dads, and you can vote on our TV dads bracket.
Yeah, just something fun to do. There's a couple contests on there. We'll be telling you about the other Father's Day giveaway with Gaston's later on in the show. We'll get back to Heston Kjerstad. We're brought to you by World of Wireless, 877-305-DISH. Two-year price guarantee right now with World of Wireless. They got the new location next door to Frank Row Furniture in Barling. It's right at the light, right next door to them. They're also now a Google Home store, so Google Nest, Google cameras, anything for home automation that Google does with their Nest and their Hub and all these things, they can now do and install for you with World of Wireless. Check it out. Plus Dish, they're a premier Dish dealer. Two-year price guarantee and a $100 Visa gift card. 877-305-DISH for WOW, World of Wireless.
A lot of great sound bites from Heston Kjerstad last night. Got an email from Michael Minshew, who's the Arkansas baseball SID, that said Heston Kjerstad was going to be having a Zoom call with everyone. And one of the more important things that he said on the Zoom call last night was the question I asked him about Dave Van Horn. For those that weren't listening to the first segment, I listed out the statistic that Heston was drafted in the 36th round back out of high school by the Seattle Mariners. Since then, he has risen over 35 rounds and over 1,000 draft picks to be number two overall. And he credits that to Dave Van Horn.
He took a chance on me when I was just a high schooler, gave me an offer, a scholarship to come play at his great program. And, you know, I'll always be thankful for that. And, you know, while I was there, he took such good care of me, whether it was helping me reach a new level or helping me with whatever I needed. He was always there, and he was a father figure there for me, in my opinion, for all of us when we're away from home. And there's no other college coach in the country I would ever want to play for than Dave Van Horn.
I mean, you think about the consistency that he showed since arriving to campus. SEC Freshman of the Year, helps get that team to the College World Series, then backs it up with a really good sophomore campaign. And then this past season, 16-game hitting streak to start, batting over 400. The guy is as lethal as it gets, has the power, is a lefty, and a big part of the reason of his development is the guy he just referred to, Dave Van Horn.
Yeah, and you know, we mentioned earlier just the stats that Dave have had now, what, the sixth first-rounder with Dave, ninth overall program history, second highest ever Razorback drafted as far as the second position overall. Jeff King was number one in 86. To me, this is just how you continue to build the program if you're Dave Van Horn, because you got evidence, hard evidence of what you just led this segment with. Here's a kid that was 36th out of high school, 36th round, taken by Seattle. He invests the time and the development. Dave Van Horn and this program have the facilities and the know-how to do, which is, I believe, better development. You're probably going to get in rookie ball, A ball, where you're in the pros at that point. It's not the big leagues, but you're professionally playing baseball for a check, and they don't have the facilities and the travel and the way of life that you're going to get at Arkansas. That investment of time, that decision, I mean, his signing bonus is going to be nearly $8 million, mm-hmm. 7.8 or whatever I saw last night is what that position is kind of slotted for. You think it was a good decision professionally and financially? Of course. I mean, here's just another way to convince future recruits or kids on your roster that are thinking about maybe not coming back for a fourth year. Hey, here's why you might want to stick around Dave Van Horn's program.
And on the note of his signing bonus, I know that Dominique Fletcher, his former teammate at the U of A, was joking, hey, congrats, get this guy to the bigs. Oh, yeah, by the way, you have dinners now.
Yeah,
you're buying those
exactly.
With the money that Heston is going to be making. And it's just wild to me, the money that was made last night. And you talk about the development aspect. I saw Chris Burke, who is a baseball analyst for ESPN, tweet that's out last night. Seven of the first-round draft picks, the first seven, were college players. Not high school players, college players. That shows not only the development that you saw from Dave Van Horn and his guys at Arkansas, but college baseball coaches know what they're doing. There's a reason behind. Listen, if you're an absolute stud, like, for example, Kumar Rocker, who's a pitcher for the Vanderbilt Commodores, was going to be a projected top 10 pick coming out of high school. Incredible. His mom? Nope, you're going to school. You're getting a Vanderbilt education, and you're going to play for Tim Corbin. But there are guys that are going to be drafted, like a Bryce Harper or some just absolute other studs that have played high school baseball and played travel baseball and stuff. They're going to get drafted like first round or whatever. If you don't want to go to college for that, I completely understand it. But a guy in like Heston's case, where you were drafted out of high school, but you're 36 overall, and so many others that were picked last night, college, that was just, those are perfect examples to showcase, hey, if I go to a competent baseball program with a coach that knows what he's doing, my stock's going to go up. Well,
and the fact that you play in the Southeastern Conference, all the baseball insiders, are, and I've heard Clay talk about this a number of times when he's talked to scouts and other people, they believe SEC baseball, professional baseball people, MLB people, the SEC is equivalent to double-A ball. So essentially you get to come in and prove yourself at what the people evaluating you believe is equivalent to double-A. So they know if you can hack it and you can handle it in the SEC West and you're a standout, you know, I don't know how – it won't take him long to get to double-A ball, probably triple-A ball, very shortly whenever their structure for minor league ball resumes. That's how you climb up to the pros within a year or so, like Benintendi did. What Andrew spent, what, a year or something like that in minor league ball before he was on the big league roster? You know, I would assume Heston's going to have maybe even a faster rise to the big league roster. But that's how you do it, because you've proven yourself at what's equivalent to a double-A level for a couple of years now.
One of the things that I learned and really kind of supplemented my knowledge with SEC baseball early on doing the show with Phil was constantly, and Phil's a baseball guy, his knowledge seems unsurpassing when it comes to this subject. He pointed out, Ty, you know SEC baseball is better than SEC football, right? It's mm-hmm. like, no way, that can't be true. This is just your baseball bias. The more you study the analytics, the more you study the titles, the more you study the coaches, it's actually true. Not to diminish what SEC football has been the last couple of years, because we know the juggernauts that have come out of that conference, but SEC baseball is the real deal. For example, last night, 9 players in the first round were drafted out of the SEC. 5 of the first 11, 3 of the top 5.
Yeah, which no conference has ever had 3 of the first 5.
And doesn't, I mean, that does not come close. And you mentioned the minor league cool stuff. There's a connection within the Baltimore Orioles organization, and that's your former dominant Friday night pitcher. It's Blaine Knight. Blaine called Heston a couple days ago, then called him this morning, then called him yesterday morning, and then called him after he was drafted last night. Heston's really excited to be back in the same organization as the former Arkansas pitcher.
He actually gave me a call this morning, and he wanted to wish me luck, and he was just telling me, enjoy it, embrace the moment. You're going to remember that day for the rest of your life. And he was like, good luck. He's like, wherever you go, you'll be in a great place. And then actually, like 30 minutes ago, he gave me a call. I answered it. And he was pumped. And, you know, I'm pumped, too, to be back on a team with Blaine. We got along great while I was at Arkansas. And, you know, we're both talking about playing on the same team again soon and how we're both looking forward to it.
I don't know how much of a mentor Blaine Knight was to Heston Kjerstad, but if you remember, Blaine was a junior when Heston was a freshman. And so you have the upperclassmen kind of bringing in the lowerclassmen. They would do press conferences together. They'd be seen just having fun in the dugout and stuff. So there seems to be a solid relationship there. And when you venture off into a place that you've never been or the next level of competition, which Heston is doing, it's nice to have someone you know from your past there. Unfortunately, another player is also there, Adley Rushman, who was drafted number 1 overall, the former Oregon State catcher. So I'm guessing Adley's going to give – he's probably going to rib or jab Heston a little bit about what happened in 2017. Just a little.
Maybe.
Not too much.
But,
just a little.
You know, I just wonder if Blaine knew anything. It seems like from Dave may have been tipped off that this could have happened. I wonder if Blaine Knight had any knowledge. My guess would be no, that a player within the organization has no clue what their draft board looks like. But they sure had a lot of contact there. And I think it's cool to maybe have a team, if you're not a big fan of one team or another, you know, if you just want to adopt a team. I don't think there's a lot of people that don't like the Orioles here for a lot of reasons. But, hey, this be a great way to adopt a team that's got a couple of Razorbacks.
Yeah, no, exactly right. And listen, when a Razorback ends up at an organization, regardless if you had any connection to it previously or if you did like them or so, that the tie changes a little bit because you're like, oh, well, I love this guy, so I can't hate this team anymore. Mm-hmm. I can't not care about this team anymore because the guy I used to love, that being Heston Kjerstad, that being Blaine Knight, Well, they're playing there now, so I have to have some tie or allegiance to that. Back to his Arkansas memories. Heston was asked about, hey, what do you want your legacy to be with Arkansas fans? Here's how he answered that last night.
It's probably the same memories that I'll remember for my legacy there. And it's the two trips to Omaha we made. You know, those were unreal. Those team accomplishments we're able to do together and being able to jump on top of a dog pile at the end of the season to clinch that was an unreal feeling. And also to be a part of the first two teams that were able to go back to back in the rich history of Arkansas Razorback baseball. You know, that's something I'll never forget. I want all the Arkansas fans to always remember.
We brought this up earlier. This team might not have gone back to Omaha, but from an individual standpoint, Tommy, Heston could have won the Golden Spikes.
Yeah.
He could have been the second guy in Razorback history, like Andrew Benintendi, to win that award. Now, we don't know because he only got in 16 games, which he got a hit in every single game he participated in this season, was batting over 400. But not only you're missing out on the potential to three-peat back to Omaha, which I don't know if that would happen, but just the individual aspect, we didn't get to see him go after slash win an award that he could have deserved.
And whether who knows how the season would have played out, how Arkansas' season would have been. You got to remember that team that Benintendi was on didn't have a great regular season. He won it, but they ended up in the College World Series because they got hot late. They went 0-2 at that College World Series. But and it was a good Razorback team. It wasn't one of the great Razorback teams. But I think he definitely would have been in the mix for that. So my point was, even if Arkansas' season was off a little bit, his individual numbers were going to stand out to a point to put him in the mix to win that award.
So you heard him talk about David Horn giving him a chance to play for his great program. I think Heston was being very humble because he was still a good baseball player out of high school. You don't get drafted out of high school.
Nope.
Now, he wasn't a top or premier or like one of the top 10, 5 high school prospects like some of the other kids that he went up against. But he does feel like he still has a chip on his shoulder. He felt like he had it in Arkansas. Now he feels like he has it at the Baltimore Orioles because it was an odd pick for the Orioles. Not in the sense that it was odd to us because we've seen Heston Kjerstad. We know what he can do behind the plate. But a lot of Baltimore Oriole fans and a lot of MLB people were questioning. It's like, you drafted pretty high. Austin Martin sitting there, standout Vanderbilt player. Asa Lacy, standout Texas A&M pitcher. Why are you going after this guy? So he feels like he has a chip on his shoulder and something to prove.
I always have something to prove every time I go out there on the field. And I'm just going to keep playing baseball how I always have, because when I went to Arkansas, you know, there was a lot of people that thought I shouldn't have been there. When I started as a freshman, they thought I shouldn't have started as a freshman. And I proved them wrong. And then same sophomore year, they thought it was 1 year luck and prove that wrong. So, you know, it's just another thing, and people can just sit back and watch, and I'll keep doing my thing, and I'm pretty sure I'll slowly change a lot of minds, and they'll realize why my name was called so early if they don't understand now.
Even drafted second overall, even all his accomplishments through the U of A, he still feels like there's pressure on him, especially because he was drafted a lot higher than expected by the Baltimore Orioles.
What we learned from watching The Last Dance, that even the greatest of all times, and Heston's not the greatest of all time, even they find ways to put chips on their shoulder, find things to motivate them. This may be one of those things that drives and fuels that motivation. Everybody's wired a little different. So, hey, believe me, they pay attention to the chatter. They know what's going on. And his statement there to open that soundbite, I've always got something to prove when you go out every day. You got to find a way to fuel that desire and that motivation. And, you know, when someone maybe says you don't deserve something you got, there's another log on the fire for you.
And you mentioned The Last Dance. It was funny that you bring that up because I'm thinking about the Michael Jordan, the different scenarios, whether he felt like someone didn't say hi to him, snubbed or whatever.
Yeah.
George Karl, prior to the 1996 NBA Finals, he was the head coach of the Seattle Supersonics, and they saw each other in a restaurant, and Carl didn't come over and say hi, apparently, according to Jordan. I don't know how true that is or not, because I felt like there was some stuff that was fabricated in that documentary, but he felt like that, all right, that's all I needed. I'm good.
Yeah.
But you know what's funny about that? If Carl came over and said hi, he would probably find something about
exactly
what Carl said to use it as motivation, because as you mentioned, the great ones find that extra level, that extra need of motivation to get them that much more over the edge. Because in competition, you have to not only have just the fuel and the fire to win, but you have to have something a little extra. Now, as you mentioned, you're not comparing Heston Kjerstad to the greatest basketball player of all time, but you do like what he said last night in reference to what he's going to try and accomplish in the Baltimore Orioles organization. No,
my point is, if a great of all time like Michael Jordan, maybe the greatest athlete in any sport we've ever seen, has to find ways to throw logs on the fire to keep that fire stoked up, then you know you're seeing something at a player that's trying to prove himself now at a new level. You're kind of starting over now. You're coming in as the rookie. You've got to make the big league club now, so you got a brass ring to go after.
What about what he brings to the table? We know that he can just absolutely stroke it from behind the plate. What about his other attributes? He labeled those as well.
I'm going to be an impact player for sure, you know, and bring a left-handed bat and a lineup that has power to all parts of the field, left, right, and center. And, you know, I also bring a good glove to the outfield, whether it's left or right or wherever they put me, you know, I'll be a solid defender. And then also one of the things that really contributes to helping a team win, which is the most important thing, is my camaraderie that I'm able to develop with my teammates, and the type of teammate I am to them really will be a big part for me in the clubhouse.
You know, you hear him, the way he presents himself, the way he's, because that's a statement right there, how he's selling himself. Hey, I bring power to all parts of the park. I'm a great outfielder. Listen to just his words through all these sound bites you've pulled for this morning, how well he presents himself. I'm certain he did the same thing when sitting down with front office officials from the various teams, and probably a lot of it over a Zoom call like this press conference was last night. He sells himself real well. That's why a team like Baltimore, and I'm sure many more behind them, are disappointed they didn't get him. Baltimore's excited they did get him because they know what kind of person they're getting. That last thing he mentioned about, I can sell myself, and what he's to my teammates and the camaraderie. What he's saying is, I can get along with other people in the clubhouse. You know, I know how to go in and not create dissension within the clubhouse and to make friends within the clubhouse. Those are the kind of people you want that can be leaders for you. I think he does a tremendous job of just selling himself on what kind of solid individual he is beyond just being a great player.
As far as his outfielder skills go, he had a few blips his freshman year, as many freshmen do in the outfield, but he's definitely improved on that aspect. And you mentioned the camaraderie within the clubhouse. Did anyone ever hear anything about dissension within the Arkansas locker room involving Heston Kjerstad? Now, maybe Dave Van Horn keeps that stuff under wraps and he really keeps it under the blanket and stuff. Maybe we just don't hear anything, but I think it's important that one, if not the best player on your team these last couple years, there didn't seem to be any bad words said by his teammates or rumors you heard about on what he was like in that locker room.
Going to be fun watching his career develop the next few seasons there in Baltimore. Hey, even in these challenging times, Academy Mortgage and Matt Fowler are open and ready to serve you. Matt's committed to meeting all of your financing and refinancing needs with the highest level of service, and they have the new mobile app. Matt can get you set up this for quick pre-approval. You simply fill out the application, all the disclosures, and upload the documents, and Matt gets to work quickly on getting your new home loan taken care of. They can take care of all your financing options for a new home buyer or getting that refinancing done at a lower rate. Call Matt Fowler today, 870-580-5210. That's 870-580-5210 for Academy Mortgage, your first choice home lender. Go online to academymortgage.com.
Coming up, I want to talk what the Arkansas basketball lineup could look like. That's next on the Morning Rush.
Now is the perfect time to invest in your own backyard oasis. And Burton Pools and Spas has everything you need. Semi-in-ground pools starting at just $9,997. Hot tubs starting as low as $2,695. And that includes delivery, cover, and startup chemicals. And with 60 luxury spas in stock, you're sure to find the perfect one for you. Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
Are your appliances struggling? Do you need that part and not sure where to go? Mid-South Distributing has you covered with 9 locations in the Arkansas area. Appliance parts and accessories for all major brands of appliance. Mid-South Distributing has you, the customer, in mind when you are needing that part for your appliance. Mid-South Distributing. Check out MidSouthParts.com to find your location near you. Mid-South Distributing. We're in your neighborhood.
Tommy Kraft here for The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building your next fence. The Fence Man recently built new gates for my existing fence. The whole process was easy, quick, and most importantly, affordable. Plus, 18-month same-as-cash financing with approved credit is now available with The Fence Man. If you need a new fence, gate, or anything that involves a fence, call The Fence Man, 479-782-3936. That's 782-3936. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work.
If you have experience transporting frozen and refrigerated goods and want to be part of a trucking family with insurance and be home every week, you need to contact Brent Higgins Trucking. Since 1997, Brent Higgins Trucking in Mulberry has been proudly delivering to and from various areas of the United States, including but not limited to Oklahoma, Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi. Brent Higgins Trucking, where you're a name, not a number. Contact them at 479-997-2366 or at Brent Higgins Trucking.
Things are really heating up at Rath Auto Resources. Hi folks, Larry Rath here with our biggest sale of the year, the Summer Sales Drive. It's the best time to save on a great inventory of Rath Road Ready vehicles, each one hand-picked and inspected in our Meineke Car Care Center to ensure you're buying the best pre-owned vehicle you'll find anywhere. And we're making it easy with $1,200 Rath Auto Relief to use as you choose on select inventory and summer savings on every car in stock. Like a 2018 Hyundai Elantra SEL, low miles and fully equipped, just $13,993, or payments as low as zero down and $219 a month while they last. If you're keeping the car you have, let us get it ready for summer in the Meineke Car Care Center with free AC checks, half off brakes, and buy three, get one free on all tires. Summertime is fun time and the right time to save on a nicer, newer car during the Summer Sales Drive at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources, and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online at rathauto.com.
Attention Arkansas Valley Electric Cooperative members. Do you need a better internet provider? One who treats you like a member and not a number? Then check out our new fiber internet services from Wave Rural Connect. We are bringing state-of-the-art, high-speed fiber, internet, TV, and phone services right into your home. If you are an Arkansas Valley Electric Cooperative member, go to WaveRuralConnect.com to sign up. That's WaveRuralConnect.com or call 1-833-4WAVE-RC. Arkansas Valley Electric Cooperative and Wave Rural Connect. Change the communities we serve.
New Bud Light Seltzer, huh?
Yep.
And it tastes like a hard seltzer, not a beer?
Yep.
So it's light and refreshing?
Yep.
With a hint of fruit flavor?
Yep.
And 100 calories?
Yep.
You said this is Bud Light Seltzer?
Yep.
Well, I need to try it.
Yep.
Oh, that tastes great.
Yep.
Now, wait, are you just yepping me?
Nope.
Bud Light Seltzer, unquestionably good. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Seltzer. IRC Beers, beer in Texas, St. Louis, Missouri.
Are your real estate investments being properly managed? Are you sending a check or cashing a check each month? If you're tired of your current property managers, then call Trinity Multifamily. Trinity will qualify your tenants and leases, inspect your properties, and take care of maintenance and provide you with web-based access to current financial reports, leases, and pictures of your property. Call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
River City Bistro is open for lunch and dinner 7 days a week. River City's dining room is set up for your safety and comfort, or enjoy outdoor dining on the spacious patio. River City Bistro, locally owned and open Monday through Friday, 11 to 8. Weekends, 10 till 8 for brunch and dinner. Want River City curbside to go? Search on Facebook or Instagram for River City Bistro and order right from the page or on the website at rcbistro.com. River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
Ridge of high pressure builds in, locks in for the next few days. Looking at sunny skies, our high temperatures this afternoon mid-80s, mainly clear upper 50s tonight. And then tomorrow, lots of sunshine, a little bit warmer with our high in the upper 80s. We're right back to near 90 Saturday. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Hey, this is Matt Jenkins. Be sure to listen to Halftime weekdays from 12 to 2 on ESPN 95.3 and hitthatline.com.
KERX, Paris Fort Smith.
Hey, we can't make you a morning person, but we can make your mornings.
ESPN 95.3.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Broadcasting live from the Bud Light Studio.
You're causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of lions, tigers, and bears, but they even one Razorback. Number one.
This is The Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
That's cool. I can dig it.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
A lot of people are wondering what the starting lineup for the Arkansas basketball program is going to look like this upcoming season. So we're going to play coach here in this segment to who we think would be the starting lineup. Or just put position here, position there, and how we'd go about that. But before we get into that, I want to tell you about Breeden RV on a recruiting Thursday. Tom Murphy set to join us about 15 minutes. Richard Davenport, top of the hour at 8 o'clock. Breeden RV has the annual trade-up event going on right now where you can get up to $5,000 up to NADA trade-in value. You can trade up and take advantage of rock-bottom prices on all new and used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. You get free maintenance for life on everything new at Breeden RV. Plus, they can take care of all your service needs on all makes and models today. Just stop by BreedenRV.com right now to check out their selection or come see Ransom at the game between Van Buren and Alma on Alma Highway. Breeden RV, where adventures begin. With the addition of Justice Smith transfer from Indiana, there's a lot of questions that have been raised. Who's going to be in the starting lineup? And it's not like those questions were answered previously before he committed to Arkansas, but that adds an additional question mark to who's going to be in the starting lineup. And the group right now is as follows. Now, these are just in the order. You got K.K. Robinson, Devontae Davis, Jalen Williams, and Moses Moody as freshmen. The three transfers, Justin Smith, Vance Jackson, and Jalen Tate. The guys already on the roster, Reggie Chaney, Ethan Henderson, Connor Vanover, J.D. Notte, Dedezie Sills, and Isaiah Joe if he elects to stay with this basketball team. So, Tommy, I'll let you start. Who do you think should be the starting five of this rotation?
For me, the point guard would be, we've talked about Dedezie Sills, whether he comes off the bench or he's your guard, you're handling the ball there. Who's going to handle running the point? To me, it's Sills or Devontae Davis. And I'm not sure about Davis's ball handling skills. I'm going to put Sills there for now, but he has been comfortable in that coming off the bench role. Isaiah Joe, obviously, is a guy that, you know, you can start with him. He's probably the most surefire lock if he's back with the team. Moses Moody seems like a guy everybody agrees is going to be a starter on this team as a true freshman. I think it gets interesting with the fours because you've only got Ethan Henderson back, which I know we're going to talk about some news that was out on him yesterday, and Reggie Chaney. Vanover, we've only seen play in the red-white game. Then you got some of these transfers in that we're not as familiar with. I'm going to put Vanover in there just based on size. You just can't coach 7 feet, and they've got it there. And where I'm struggling is who gets that last forward spot. Do you really have a true five? I know Vanover fits it height-wise, but he's not really a back-to-the-basket, you know, true five, going to back someone down kind of guy. He's more of an outside shooter. So 2 4-and-a-halves or whatever. I'm struggling with who gets that fifth spot. So I'm pretty solid on four. Maybe we can talk through who that extra forward slash inside presence to be a rebounder should be. And I'd probably go with a better defender of some of these transfer players. Who's the best defender you can put on the floor there? Because I think you've got enough points with the guys in the backcourt.
Jalen Tate's an all-Horizon League defender. Justin Smith out of Indiana is a good defender as well. Vance is, I think, just an okay defender. I don't know if that's his strength. So if you're looking for a defender in that role, you would probably go Jalen Tate or Justin Smith. For me, now this is not going to happen. This might be an end-of-game situation, the death lineup as of sorts. But with the shooting that you have, I would love to see a starting lineup. Now, again, I'm under the impression that this is not going to happen. This is just my fantasy. This is just my world. Isaiah Joe, Justin Smith, Vance Jackson, Jalen Tate, and Moses Moody. And you say, well, Ty, there's not really like tall power forwards or centers in there. But you have five guys that can really stretch the floor. Smith can kind of stretch the floor, not so much, I guess, and Jalen Tate's not so much. You have to, at least three guys can shoot. But everyone that I just listed is 6'5 or above. Isaiah 6'5, Justin Smith 6'7, Vance Jackson 6'9, Jalen Tate 6'5, and Moses Moody 6'5, 6'6. So that lineup to me would be so fun to watch. Do I think it's going to happen? Probably not starting. Maybe end of game situations. Realistically, here's what I think is going to play out. I'm really curious to see what happens with Desi Sills. And we saw his end of year production just vault up just fantastically last season. How does that change heading into this season? Is he put back into the starting lineup? Does he really enjoy coming off the bench? Because if he enjoys coming off the bench, then I think you're down to probably three guys starting at point guard. Jalen Tate, K.K. Robinson, and Devontae Davis. Now, if it plays out like that, here's what I think is going to happen. I think K.K. and Moses are going to be the two freshmen that start in this ball club. Then you go back and forth between Justin Smith or Jalen Tate playing the three, Vance Jackson at the four, and then Connor Vanover at the five. I'd love to see Jalen Williams get that starting role. I think that'd be cool to see three freshmen on the court. But I think if you're going to say two freshmen, and I really went back and forth on this last night because I can't decide if I think that Jalen Williams can overtake Connor or if Connor already being in the system 1 year, getting that development year in the offseason, I think he's probably going to be at least hold him out. That's not to say Jalen Williams out of Fort Smith Northside can't overtake him eventually in that starting role, but right now I'd probably say Connor's above him.
Yeah. I still go back to the things that Eric Musselman has talked about, his philosophy of roster management and having essentially four guys that are in transfer redshirt years. Is that out the window this year?
That's what I've been asking for quite some time. We asked him on this very radio show. I asked him straight up. I was like, hey, you've had this management style for whatever. All your guys are eligible.
Right.
Now you have 14 and 13 eligible scholarships. We'll see what happens when you get that Ethan Henderson thing. But that's maybe just 1 year in the SEC changed his philosophy after being in the Mountain West for 4 years.
Or has it? I mean, I don't know. I mean, this is going to be the interesting thing. First of all, getting down to 13 players, how does that develop and work through itself? And then also, you know, you don't think any of these four freshmen would be redshirt candidates, but I can't see him playing all of these guys either. I can't see him completely abandoning that and, hey, we're just going to have everybody. Because the reasoning, the philosophy there is I've got guys that aren't going to be unhappy about the lack of minutes because not everybody can play. So it keeps the locker room from turning into, having low morale in the locker room because guys are upset they're not getting to play enough. So I think it's going to be really interesting to see if any of these freshmen are tabbed for red shirts or maybe even some of these guys that haven't used the red shirt up that are in upper classes because you got a long list of juniors on this team, and I'm not sure who has a red shirt left, but a lot of them do, I'm certain. Would some of those be a candidate? I don't know. I just find it interesting. I can't see him completely abandoning his philosophy.
We need to update everyone what's going on with Ethan Henderson. And Tommy is the legal analyst of the show. I'll let you take this away.
Legal analyst? I just know that during our show, there was some news that started to surface about what I would call dueling restraining orders between him and his girlfriend or fiance. There's apparently a child on the way, and she was making accusations. They have restraining orders against each other. There were some accusations of things with Ethan there and some things that led to the restraining order. His claims were that she had made physical threats against him. So there was really a lot of things back and forth and some allegations about use of marijuana involved and just reading from the report. So I just think it's interesting. It's personal drama that's getting played out in front of the media because you're a Razorback. And does this mean that Ethan Henderson's going to be the guy that redshirts? Not necessarily.
Yeah.
Or the guy that's off the team, not red shirts, but off the team.
Interesting to keep an eye on that as we continue on with this season.
Hey, Mid-South Distributing is the place to find your parts and accessories. If you need to repair any appliance, whether it's a GE, Cafe, Hotpoint, or Whirlpool, or all other major brands of appliances, they have the parts to help you with that. And with 9 locations in Arkansas, there's one near you. Go online to MidSouthParts.com to find a Mid-South Distributing location in your neighborhood. Mid-South Distributing. It's all about you, the customer. They are in your neighborhood.
877-377-6963. Tom Murphy of the Arkansas Democrat Gazette joins us now.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
Hi, I'm Bill Bolton of NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins. Newsflash, gold is at a 7.5-year high and currently at $1,683 per ounce. There has never been a better time than now to sell your unworn and broken jewelry. Turn that jewelry into amazing amounts of cash. We purchase diamond rings, diamond engagement rings, and sterling silver flatware and hollowware. We're also buying David Yurman, Stephen Lagos, John Hardy, Constantino, Tiffany & Company, and more. The time is now to empty out that safety deposit box or jewelry chest. What's in your safety deposit box could be worth thousands. Not sure your items are real or just want to find out what your valuables are worth? Stop by and let one of our expert staff give you a free evaluation while you wait. Have gold or silver coins or bullion? We buy that as well. Don't sell them through an estate sale or auction and get less money. Can't make it to us, we make house calls. NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins, Bentonville, Fayetteville.
It's time for the annual trade-up event at Breeden RV, going on through June 30th. Trade up and get up to $5,000 on NADA trade-in value. Take advantage of rock-bottom prices on all new and used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. Head to Breeden RV's trade-up event and get free maintenance for life on everything new. Breeden RV will also take care of your service needs on all makes and models. Shop today at BreedenRV.com, then come see Breeden RV between Van Buren and Alma on Alma Highway. Breeden RV, where adventures begin. See dealer for details.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC has over 200 pre-owned vehicles to choose from luxury to economy and everything in between, including over 50 great vehicles with payments under $250 a month, certain to fit your needs and your budget. And at Harry Robinson Buick GMC, you always get more for your trade. 50 vehicles with payments under $250 a month at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off I-540 in Fort Smith.
The Golf Nut, located at 5121 Towson Avenue, is open, and you don't want to miss these upcoming events. The TaylorMade Fitting Experience will be June 18th from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Callaway Golf Fitting Day will be June 20th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And the Titleist Custom Fitting Day will be July 3rd from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. with only 4 to 5 spots available. All of these events will be by appointment only, so call the Golf Nut today to reserve your spots. While you're there, check out the great selection of shoes and apparel, and check Facebook for daily specials. The Golf Nut, Fort Smith's number one golf shop since 1994.
At AOG, we realize some customers are facing challenges because of the pandemic. We're here to help. AOG can offer you a wide array of payment options. Please call us at 1-800-842-5690 or visit AOGC.com. Manage your account online 24/7 by clicking on login/register in the upper right corner. You can also simplify your life by enrolling in electronic billing, auto pay, and average monthly payments. Thank you for being a valued AOG customer. We're all in this together.
Elite Roofing is a locally owned roofing contractor. If you're building a new home or maybe need a new roof on your existing home, Elite Roofing can take care of you. Elite Roofing is known for their dependability and reliability. Just ask any of their satisfied customers. They are licensed and insured, and references are available upon request. If you need a roof, call your local roofing contractors. Elite Roofing, 478-8668. That's 478-8668. Elite Roofing, 478-8668.
Art's Barbecue and Burgers is back and ready to see you in their dining room. Bring your mask and your appetite to Art's. Wade, Morgan, and all the staff have missed seeing you and can't wait to serve you. And they have everything set for your safety. So gather your crew and come on in to Art's Barbecue and Burgers for dine-in, drive-thru, and curbside to go. It's Art's Barbecue and Burgers, 8203 Rogers Avenue, next to Aaron's in Fort Smith.
Kevin Hickey Law has a great team of people who are dedicated to your legal cares. Kevin Hickey's law team is made up of experienced, caring individuals centered around divorce, child and custody, DHS matters, and more, serving the Fort Smith area and Northwest Arkansas. Make the right decision. Call Kevin Hickey Law at 479-434-2414 and for Northwest Arkansas, 479-802-6560 or the web at kevinhickeylaw.com, where our clients are our main priority from start to finish.
Tri-Hill Turf offers the highest quality turf and pest services. Hey, you say those are big words. Well, let's see. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has a company agronomist, state and nationally certified technicians, free soil testing, and they even have precision GPS guided application equipment. Now that's high tech. For over 30 years, Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has used the latest application technology, and they strive for turf and pest excellence. They are your local turf and pest experts. Call the local team at 782-0404. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest.
Evans Body Shop wants you to know that we are here for you. During this uncertain time, let us take the wheel and get your car repaired so you are ready to roll when the time comes. We offer pickup and delivery and will sanitize your vehicle during your complimentary detail that is done with all repairs. Don't want to get out at all? We have you covered. We offer a mobile estimating tool that allows you to take a few pictures and we will email or text your estimate directly to you. Check out our website or Facebook for more details.
Evans Body Shop, where we meet the nicest people by accident.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
Well, let's get those nerds!
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 What are we waiting for?
Just say, Alexa, play ESPN Arkansas.
ESPN Arkansas from TuneIn.
Got to get to Tom Murphy of the Arkansas Democrat Gazette coming up in just a second. If you want to get in a question for Tom, 877-377-6963. Before we go to Tom, I want to tell you about Trinity Multifamily.
Yeah, if you invest in real estate only to find out you're investing as much of your time as you are your money, if you're tired of the phone ringing at the worst possible times, tired of dealing with all the hassles and the frustrations that can come along with multifamily investment property, call our friends at Trinity Multifamily. They can take care of all of your property management needs. They manage over 20,000 units in 15 different states. Call them today. They can help you. 479-452-1817. That's 452-1817. Or look online to learn more about Trinity at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, they are your teammate in the real estate game.
Tom, I got lucky last night. My roommate came in, and I was just going to wait a little bit to turn on the MLB draft because I thought Heston was going to be drafted later on, down 7, 8, 9, 10. And my roommate made me turn it on basically when the draft started. How shocked were you when Heston's name was called number 2 overall last night?
It was pretty surprising. Matt Jones and I worked pretty closely together, Matt with Whole Hog and the paper. And he went out for a little bike ride. He's like, hey, man, you know, I think things will be okay. Just give me a call if he gets picked early on. I'm like, okay. I made some mashed potatoes and cream corn, and I had just sat down on the couch because, you know, there was 15 or 20 minutes there where they opened the draft, so to speak. And then Spencer Torkelson was taken, and I'm sitting on the couch eating my plate of mashed potatoes and cream corn and really enjoying it. And my jaw dropped when he went number 2. And, you know, you just swing into action. It's funny how I was like you. I read all the pre-draft predictions that he'd be, you know, maybe 7 at the earliest to the Pirates.
Mm-hmm.
But the MLB pipeline, I think, had him ranked about 10th and all. So, you know, if you do the projections, 10 minutes per pick, if he gets picked 7th, I mean, that's in the second hour of the show. And then, bam, he goes. And I'm just so excited for him. He's such a great kid and really enjoyed covering him these 2 years plus a little bit. And wish we could have seen him and Casey Martin, Casey Opis, the rest of this crew kind of have another good season. Because right now, Arkansas baseball is the ticket. And, you know, basketball is coming along pretty strong. We think they're going to – the way they're recruiting, they're going to be good. And football, we think, is on the right track. But Arkansas baseball – That's a primo sport to watch, and there's so many high-caliber players here and who they go up against. I mean, you're watching Asa Lacy get picked and Emerson Hancock and Austin Martin and all these other SEC guys, mm-hmm. and we've seen them all play, and it's top flight right now.
Tom, on the subject of draft and the evaluation and stuff, the stat that I keep going back to is the one that Michael Minshew, I know, sent to you and sent to other Arkansas media members last night, that Heston rose from the 36th round to the number 2 overall pick, which is 35 rounds and over 1,000 draft picks. I can't seem to get over that stat, man. That's the longest draft separation in the history of Razorback baseball, and he credited Dave Van Horn for that. How much credit does Dave actually deserve for Heston's rise from back when he was drafted in high school?
Well, it's Dave, it's Nate Thompson, his hitting coach, it's the program, and also a guy like Heston Kjerstad, whose parents wanted him to go to school, he wanted to go to school. Teams know that, and they draft him later than maybe he would have based on his talent. But he certainly improved himself. But he jumped onto the stage as a freshman, as we all know, in a prime position. I mean, he was hitting in the 2-3, 4-5 hole, I think, that entire freshman year.
Mm-hmm.
And he was up to the challenge. He hit a bunch of home runs, hit for average, and just improved his swing. He cut down on his strikeouts, as the analyst on TV reported last night, because he did have, I think, 63 strikeouts as a sophomore. But he got better. And so just very excited to see where his talent will take him, and hope he can get to the big leagues in a similar time frame that, say, Andrew Benintendi did.
Tom, do you think the lack of the end of the season, only getting to play, 16 games or whatever it was, and not having the last few months of the season helped or hurt? Because it's hard to say it didn't help when he went number 2 overall and all the projections had him at 7. There's only one more spot to improve. So I'm having trouble overcoming the idea that not playing this season and what he did show in that abbreviated season helped him climb and become more comfortable with these team executives.
Yeah, I mean, what he had shown, the more discipline at the plate, power to all fields as he had shown his first 2 seasons, all that helped him. Now, if you ask him, his preference would have been to have played out the season, because that's what ball players do. But I don't think you can deny the fact that the stats he put up, 20 RBI, and, you know, the huge opening weekend, didn't help his draft stock, because, you know, the Orioles certainly liked what they saw. And, you know, to hear Mike Elias talking last night, the GM, they love his bat. He says this is gigantic power. And so I hope that there's a day soon where he and Blaine Knight are on the same team. And can you imagine? I mean, Adley Rutschman for Oregon State, we saw him in person at the College World Series, a switch-hitting catcher with power to all fields. I mean, the Orioles they're doing a nice job under Elias. And Heston was asked that last night about, you know, this is a building franchise. What do you think? And Heston responded that he had done a little bit of research on them and had seen the work Elias had done in helping build up the Astros. And we all know what kind of powerhouse club the Astros are, mm-hmm. whether they're getting the signals or not. And so maybe the Orioles could be on the same type of track.
Yeah. For Dave Van Horn, what kind of signal does this send to future recruits, to the current players on your roster about, I kind of described it as a flex move last night, because this is just another thing to point to for Dave and his staff about the value of coming and playing what's equivalent to what many believe is double-A ball when you play in the SEC. To me, this is a great signal, Tom, that, hey, there's a lot of value you can build at Arkansas.
Absolutely. Things have been trending in that direction. And Heston Kjerstad will be a poster guy for Dave Van Horn, to point to every recruit who comes through that new facility. Look, would you rather get the training here and be on this big stage? Because SEC baseball in the last 10, 15 years has zoomed on to a major stage. They're on TV all the time. You're going to the best ballparks. The Razorbacks are scheduling games in Houston and all these MLB parks. And you can ask a recruit, would you rather be on a bus playing A ball or double A ball for the next 2-3 years before you make your way to the majors, or do this and have a quicker and punch a quicker ticket to the MLB if you progress at the rate we believe that you can do? So it's a huge selling point, And Heston Kjerstad reinforced that last night when he talked to the media. It's a big deal. And Razorback baseball, y'all, it's recruiting like bonkers.
Talking with Tom Murphy of the Arkansas Democrat Gazette, and one of the other benefits of Heston going to Baltimore, Tom, is his former teammate, Blaine Knight's there, former Arkansas pitcher, and he seemed pretty excited to talk about. I know that was one of the questions that you were going to ask before Kyle Declanbaum took it before you did, but Heston seems really excited about that, and I think deservedly so. You've covered baseball on this team. What was their relationship like back when Heston was a freshman and Blaine was an outgoing player as an upperclassman?
Right. Well, not that that we're in the dugout or, you know, in the locker room and see how they interact with each other. And, of course, Knight was a junior who was going to go 14-0 that year and really just be the man on that staff. And Heston was a freshman. But Heston described it last night as, you know, they got along just fine. And to the point that Blaine Knight had called him yesterday morning and said, hey, man, just embrace the day. Have a fun time with this. You know, it's a once-in-a-lifetime deal. And lo and behold, you know, he gets drafted to the Orioles, and Knight calls him back. And who knows? I mean, they could be on the same team within a year or so. Hopefully they'll start being baseball soon. But, and, you know, maybe ride up into the majors together and be a part of a resurgence at Baltimore. These small market teams have to be very crafty about the way they build their rosters. I mean, but the Cleveland Indians have shown, you know, in the last decade or so, how you can be competitive for years, and the Astros have done it. Pittsburgh has risen up some and gotten the playoffs here and there. And so Baltimore, which has been down for a while, perhaps they're on the right track to getting that back to being a playoff team.
So we're talking about Blaine Knight. Tom, the last time I interviewed Blaine Knight, it was Phil and he was in a Waffle House eating with Eric Cole, which is kind of funny. How quickly do you think that they sit down and go eat somewhere, meet up as soon as Heston moves out there to Baltimore, or wherever he's moving for as far as the minor league stuff goes?
I would suspect that they would rebond quickly. And the first thing that's probably going to happen is the Orioles workout facility, and I think they're a Florida team. When everybody shows up there, and so they should be, you know, they be able to rehook up. Maybe it'll be late this summer when those things start happening. I don't know what all MLB has in mind in terms of reactivating their minor league rosters, because we're going through this weird time.
Yeah.
But hopefully it's soon. And Heston, I thought this was funny. Heston referred to himself as a kid a couple of times last night. Like, I've talked to Mike Elias, did a Zoom call with Mike Elias, and he found out what kind of a kid I am. Well, he's a young man now, and he's going to start getting paid like one, too, as soon as he signs that contract.
Absolutely. This abbreviated draft, what do you think it looks like for other Razorbacks and maybe even some of the recruits in this shortened MLB draft? How many names do you think get called over the balance of what's left?
Right. Well, I kind of rely – Matt Jones is really plugged into all this, and he thinks maybe three, maybe four, and I've talked to Dave Van Horn about this as well, of the signees could go. I mean, there was a chance last night the pitcher from down at Watson Chapel, Tink Hintz, could be drafted. A lot of teams love his easy motion as a right-handed pitcher. So it's just really a matter of signability, and because the major league teams, they want to maximize the value of what they do in this abbreviated draft. You don't want to have miss hits and stuff. So you want to allot your money, get it to people who you think you can sign. obviously we feel Casey Martin was right on the border of being a first round guy. A couple of shortstops went really late. Y'all probably saw last night, including the last pick, the guy from Arizona State, who apparently is not much of a bat, but a great defensive shortstop. Well, I think that's going to be fuel for Casey Martin to show, hey, I could have been a first rounder. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the strikeouts this year were an issue, and he's got to have more plate discipline and pitch recognition and such to help himself move up through the minors. But he'll be taken, and Dave Van Horn just feels certain Casey Opitz will go in these first five rounds. It's very likely that he'll sign. I mean, nice piece on him in the Denver Post last week about he and his two brothers. And as I mentioned, a few of these Razorbacks, the kid Wynn from Texas, is a likely guy to be drafted as well. So no matter what they'll sort out their roster and they'll be in good shape and it'll be a fun program to watch again next season.
Tom, I just think about college baseball next year, and Arkansas finds themselves not alone in this, but could be your most loaded, stacked rosters ever in the sport because your best recruits that are inbound don't get taken in this shortened draft, and then your best players that were not players that were going to go in the first, second, third, fourth, fifth rounds come back. This could be the best season as far as product on the field if we get back on the field in 2021 that we've ever seen in college baseball.
Absolutely true. I mean, you know, if this had been a normal 40-round draft, guys like Zebulon Vermillion probably would go in the top 10 or 12 rounds, which, you know, you're going to get enough money that it's worth your while to go. A guy like Caleb Bolden, who'd shown he'd come off as Tommy John, he was pitching well. I mean, just to see the way the rest of his season would have unfolded would have been really fun. And then even some hitters like Jacob Nesbitt was a sophomore, but he was draft eligible. He could have gotten drafted in a position to go ahead and leave as well. So you're talking about some, you know, borderline pro talent already that the Razorbacks should have back. Now, there could be some curveballs. I mean, some of these guys could wind up going anyway. Or, you know, they could wind up being a fifth-round draft pick if teams are just in love with them. So we'll see how it plays out. But I think you're right. I think the Razorbacks are in a position. When you add in returning talent, the signees that they feel they'll keep, and these transfers, they're going to have a really nice roster. But that's the case throughout the SEC. Mm-hmm. But Dave Van Horn has shown his formula is on track. I mean, when you're talking about three College World Series appearances since 2015, he knows what he's doing.
Tom Murphy of the Arkansas Democrat Gazette with us on the Morning Rush. Hey, Tom, so the basketball roster, we know what that looks like at this point. Tommy and I were playing around with who's going to be in the starting lineup and how they're going to go about the rotation. But for you, as a guy that covers a lot of football, it's difficult right now to see what the depth chart is. Clay was talking to us on Monday. Like, he didn't know what the depth chart's going to be. How are you working through that right now leading up to the season on what the fall depth chart is going to look like for Arkansas football?
Oh, Arkansas football, okay. I don't know. We have a pretty good feel. There's a lot of returning starters on the O-line, and you think each of those guys will win back their job. But Ricky Stromberg, who Sam Pittman was asked on Paul Feinbaum, or it could have been our last Zoom conference with him, that Stromberg, I believe, was like a team pick for Athlon. Mm-hmm. So you feel like at right guard, he'd come back, and he's up to around 300 pounds. He'd get his job back. Myron Cunningham, left tackle, his progress through the season, you'd think he'd hold on. Ty Clary the same. You know, Dahl Wagner and Noah Gatlin should be in a nice battle at the other tackle spot. So you automatically have a little more depth there. So it's the left guard job. I mean, that could be Shane Clemens to lose. He's had such a great offseason. But I think they're going to have a little more depth, and those freshmen are going to push people. Talking about St. John, Curry, and those guys, Henderson, they've got a chance to push people and give you better depth. Running back looks good with Boyd and Traylon Smith, and Hammond's coming back, and Spivey. The receiving core should be bolstered. I mean, they just have to. They have to be a team that has better success in close games, and for their offense to convert more third downs and be on the field longer. What that does for your overall, you know, gameplay, how you get through a game, and help your defense, will be phenomenal if they can do that. The depth I'm worried about is at linebacker a little bit, and then some in the secondary. They like what they have at safety. Guys like Slusher and Catalan, I think they feel like are gonna be players for them this year. And I mean, I can go on and on. I think depth will be better. I think they'll be more motivated this season. They just have to win some of these close games that we've talked about before. The Mississippi schools, Missouri, to start moving up in the ranks. And I don't know if it's not going to be an overnight deal. I don't think. But having a veteran like Franks running a system that he likes with a veteran back like Boyd and receivers that have a year of experience under their belt, they'll be a better team.
Tom, let me top off the interview with this man. Does it worry you at all that there's been an uptick in positive cases in Northwest Arkansas?
Oh, obviously. Yeah. I mean, I say it every Tuesday and Thursday with you guys that when you go out shopping, when you go to the home improvement stores, when you go to any kind of business, wear your mask. Come back to your car, have hand sanitizer in your car. Bring your groceries in and wash your hands. It's only smart. These are things that you should do pretty much anyway, but just do it and minimize the risk. Don't be around big crowds without your face mask on. I'm a little bit concerned about it, and the governor, I believe, said phase two is just about ready to go.
Yeah.
We just got to be smart about these things.
It's next Monday?
Monday right. Begins phase okay. two, which you know, essentially opens up capacities in restaurants, but if you're still doing the social distancing, many restaurants won't be able to seat a whole lot more people because they you can only do so much with the 6-foot distancing requirement.
50%,
okay. But that will help the larger, probably more chain restaurants that have 250, 300 seats get a few more people in there.
Okay. All right. Well, Tom Murphy of the Arkansas Democrat Gazette, again, joins us every Tuesday and Thursday. Probably be wise to heed Tom's advice as far as that goes. Tom, as always, we appreciate it, buddy. Have yourself a good weekend. I don't know what you're doing this weekend, but have a good time doing it. All right, bud?
Appreciate it, guys. And you know what? Things are on the upswing. You know, we're opening back up. The economy's doing better. We're going through some social change that I think is going to be good for America. My garden is getting better and better, and I think by next Tuesday I'll be telling you some good garden stuff.
Well,
everybody have a great week.
That's what I wanted to ask is how's the tomato crop coming along?
It's going beautifully. I'll say this. I've got some I've got some like 6 feet barriers on my garden because the deer got in it and ate some tomato plants last year.
Yeah.
A deer jumped over that yesterday. I saw the track. He did not stop and eat, but I am quite concerned we could have damage. Soon. I'll keep you posted.
All right. Don't let him eat all my tomatoes.
Yeah, I was going
to
say.
I'm looking forward to my sack of tomatoes at some
point. Tom, he's just looking to try and swipe some tomatoes.
I got my salt shaker ready to go.
Hell no, dear. Stay away.
Yeah.
See y'all.
All right. See ya.
Later, Tom. Yeah. Always good to catch up, Tom. You're just trying to use Tom for his tomatoes.
Anybody that's growing tomatoes that, and listen, it's been so wet, I'm a little worried about the tomato crop this year. So. Yeah, I'll take all the homegrown tomatoes I can get my hands on.
I could probably try to bring you some up from the lovely county of White County.
It's a great way to get a contract extension.
Here. Ooh.
You know, exactly.
Ooh, I mean, all right.
Ty's always talking about contracts. That's a great way to enhance your situation.
So if I bring you a big sack of tomatoes, that could project me higher than Ty.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Curry favor with a boss. Absolutely.
Got it.
So. Are you not a fan of the garden tomatoes in the summer? That is the best part of summer in Arkansas.
For us, it's always the tomatoes, but my favorite coming out of the garden was always the squash.
Yeah.
Do some boiled squash with a little bit of salt.
To me, the lake's the best part of the summer in Arkansas, but if you guys want to stick your tomatoes, you're all welcome to shove those.
One of the better things.
Okay. Maybe I haven't had – my dad has a garden in his backyard, and I haven't had one of his tomatoes in a while. Maybe I need to be enlightened on the issue.
Maybe.
But he said they call them maters in White
County.
He is.
Well,
great.
From where Andy, our buddy Andy Hodges is from, that's where they, down in Warren.
Yeah.
That's where the real tomatoes come from in Arkansas.
The good ones?
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
don't you agree, Ty?
I mean, I don't know. I haven't had a fresh tomato in I don't know how long. So I don't pretend to be country on this show or be a gardener.
No,
so.
You're a West Little Rock city slicker there. So private school city slicker.
Yeah, you hired me, so who really has the issues?
Yeah, be quiet. I got to talk here. So, anyway, let me tell you about Gaston's. Father's Day coming up. We're not too far out, a week from Sunday. Need to get registered for the Father's Day giveaway from Gaston's White River Resort and the Morning Rush. HitThatLine.com and our great sponsors. We're going to give away 7 prizes, but the grand prize, 3 nights, 2 days of fishing, $200 in the restaurant at Gaston's. All you need to do is go and register at HitThatLine.com. We'll have 6 additional winners for great prizes from businesses like Frank Rowe Furniture, Metters Lumber, True Value in Alma and Ozark, Jelco Outdoors, Big Creek Trading Company, Make-A-Wake Boats in Van Buren, and also R-Track Sales and Rentals in Clarksville. Just register online at HitThatLine.com for Gaston's White River Resort. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time.
Every time.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
Arvest Bank has been helping local businesses for more than 50 years, helping with financing, equipment needs, cash flow solutions, and more. As an SBA preferred lender, we're helping them when they need it most. Thank you to our associates who helped more than 15,000 small businesses secure SBA Paycheck Protection Program loans for more than $1.2 billion, keeping them going and their employees paid. Arvest Bank, ready to help.
906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge, now open Tuesday through Saturday, still serving all the 906 specialty items, with new menu items including fish and chips, classic club sandwiches, Caesar and Cobb salads, dine-in or carry-out, wines, top-shelf spirits, and handcrafted cocktails and cigars, all in an atmosphere that feels more like a destination, following all of the state guidelines and a state-of-the-art air filtration system for your safety. 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge, defining nightlife in downtown Fort Smith. Doors open Tuesday through Saturday at 4 p.m.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Do you own apartment complexes, condos, and rental property? Then you have made a great investment. Now make another great decision by calling Trinity Multifamily to help you maximize your return. Trinity Multifamily offers full-service property management, marketing, leasing, sales, and all the services to make your cash flow. Take the hassles and frustrations out of ownership and call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Hey, grounds guys.
Hey, what?
What's the first thing people see when they pull up to your house? That's right, the yard. Your curb appeal is everything to make a great lasting impression, and the Grounds Guys are here to help. The Grounds Guys provide spring cleanup, weed control, mowing and trimming, and anything to make your yard look its best to get that head-turning curb appeal. The Grounds Guys are a professional crew with a passion to make your yard beautiful. Call today and get $100 off any annual maintenance plan. 479-303-GUYS. That's 303-4897.
Locally owned Lumber One can handle all of your building needs. They've built their business on having great relationships with everybody from contractors and builders to the everyday build-it-yourself. Lumber One is a full-line door shop to handle all of your door, window, and trim needs. And along with lumber, roofing and drywall products, attic wall and floor insulation is available. Lumber One also does blueprint takeoff with access to design services with estimates available. So go where the pros go. Lumber One, located on Industrial Park Road in Van Buren.
Family first. My dad used to tell us that all the time. But family first wasn't just something he'd say to us. It was how he lived every day of his life. And it's how I try to live mine, too.
At Shelter Insurance, our agents are dedicated to helping provide personalized auto, home, and life protection that puts your family first.
Ask Shelter Agent Phil Hicks about a free insurance review.
Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC has over 200 pre-owned vehicles to choose from luxury to economy and everything in between, including over 50 great vehicles with payments under $250 a month, certain to fit your needs and your budget. And at Harry Robinson Buick GMC, you always get more for your trade. 50 vehicles with payments under $250 a month at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off I-540 in Fort Smith.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
Chuck,
Porterhouse, ribeye, I know exactly how you guys are feeling. In fact, I can think of only one thing that could lift my spirits right now. Beer.
Video streaming live on Facebook, Periscope, and YouTube.
The only thing that I watch on Facebook is the Morning Rush. That's it.
I want to talk about the possibility, the prospect of Arkansas having a similar type of farm system for offensive linemen within the football program that could have the same type of success going to the NFL that Arkansas's baseball team has had under Dave Van Horn, really with all different types of players, whether it's pitchers, infielders, outfielders. What can Sam Pittman do with the offensive linemen here at Arkansas, getting them to the next level? Before we do that, I want to tell you about Recruiting Thursday, which is presented by Breen RV. If you head over there right now, they have their trade-up event going on through the end of June. Get up to $5,000 off NADA trade-in value and take advantage of rock-bottom prices on new and used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. Trade up and get free maintenance for life on everything new. They're also going to take care of your service needs on all makes and models. Shop online today at BreenRV.com or come see Ransom at the game at Breen RV between Van Buren and Alma on Alma Highway. Breen RV, where adventures begin. So Arkansas has had a decent amount of offensive linemen drafted in the past decade. Let's see, we got five that have been drafted in the past decade. One first rounder in Frank Radnow. And what you're hoping is, with Sam Pittman's background of seven players that he has coached, has gone on to be just first rounders, you're hoping you can see that type of success in the coming years at Arkansas.
Yeah, and you know, you kind of asked the question, could you kind of build a farm system here? Could you get to a point where, you know, they tried to, under Bielema, build this marketing campaign around O-line, more or less. Everybody wants to be something you, but they were sitting the linemen in first-class seating. They were making putting all five of them or seven of them or whatever it was on the front of that media guide. They were really going about how this is the biggest line in all of football. I don't know if you want to carry out some of that all the way, because, God, I got tired of that stat about it being the biggest line ever when the team wasn't producing. But they were trying – it was all a marketing plan to let people know, hey, if you want to play on the O-line, come here. What you got to do is get back to a point that – what Sam Pittman has done pretty much his entire career, produce draft picks. And that's what you want to be known for. What we've been talking about this morning with baseball, you want to have the same feel around offensive line. If you become that kind of school in the SEC, you're going to win a lot of ball games just because you control the trenches. So that's where I hope they head with this thing.
Yeah, and I think that's – I mean, you look at the guys that have been drafted, Yelda Frohol to the Pats in the fourth round in 2019, Frank Ragnow, the first rounder in this class, Sebastian Tortola, Travis Swanson, who we've had on. Dan Skipper went undrafted, but he's still trying to make his way. The late Mitch Petras. I mean, there have been a decent amount of Arkansas offensive linemen in this past decade, but it's now about elevating. It's now about a couple of Frank Ragnows over the course of a decade, not just one guy that's been drafted. And I mean, you think about the history of success of Arkansas offensive linemen. Sean Andrews, I know that Jason Peters played tight end, but has gone on to have an incredible career at the left tackle position. Tony Hugo. But I mean, there's just guys that they know what they're doing.
Yep.
And you hope. Now, it's going to be interesting because he's had big uglies. And when he was at Georgia, Tennessee, Arkansas, they ran a pro-style type offense. I don't know how that's going to work with Kendall Briles bringing in his set. Running is a huge part of Kendall Briles' offense, but it's definitely going to be more mobile, more sped up. How does that change Sam Pittman and his kind of teachings down to Brad Davis as far as his offensive linemen go?
Or how does Sam Pittman change maybe a little bit of what Kendall Briles? Where do they mesh there on how they want to do it? I agree. I don't know how much downhill we're going to run between the guard and the tackle they're going to do, but you know, how much do you have to shift the pocket to accomplish the ground game? We haven't seen any of this because we didn't get to see any spring practice. We don't know exactly what this offense will look like. We've heard the term, what, veer and shoot? You know, so I'm interested to see how they mesh all of this together, because I saw yesterday where Kendall Briles was talking, and he believes he's got the offensive weapons to make this thing productive this year. So I'm excited to see it kind of start playing out. We just know, because we've seen it not work out, that when the offensive line doesn't play at an SEC level, you're not going to win those ball games more often than not.
And when you look at Wisconsin, Wisconsin's really the blueprint for just like if you look at Wisconsin and Arkansas, there's a lot of similarities there. You want to have an established running game. You want to have an established tough identity, blue collar type of program. And Barry Alvarez and company, regardless of who's been at the helm, whether it's Brett Bielema, Gary Anderson, Paul Chryst, whoever, they've had success there. And because you have that just blue-collar mentality, you hope the same thing gets with Arkansas. Because Wisconsin, now, I don't know if you'll have the same just monstrous offensive alignment that Wisconsin seems to roll out every single year, but they consistently have guys drafted at the offensive lineman position towards the NFL.
Yeah, and you know, I've heard Bielema talk about the recruiting up there, and you've heard others talk about, you know, you got all those Norwegian, Scandinavian body types that are just the recruiting grounds in that part of the country with Wisconsin and the upper Midwest lend itself to just having offensive lines with massive people. Arkansas's had a history of producing good tight ends, we know, good linemen. I think the body types are in this state. You're going to have to get players from Texas and other places, but you know, if you want to line up and just be 320, 330, 340 across the front and mash people, I think you can do that. Chad Morris's philosophy was to take the body types the other direction to make them faster and quicker on the line, and now they're having to recover from that both in recruiting and in the weight room.
Yeah, and you just need production, especially at the offensive lineman position, because when Arkansas's had success, we can talk about the quarterback position, we can talk about the skills position, but oftentimes when you think about successful Arkansas football teams, pick a college football program team out, where does it start typically? In the trenches. Those guys don't as get as much credit, whether on the offensive or defensive side of the football, but that is a massive part of the equation, a massive part of the football team and unit to have big uglies up front who can get it done. And that's why you're excited about Sam Pittman, because at one point in time, you weren't worried about just the toughness factor of this football team, because not just Sam Pittman, but just kind of the identity that he instilled within his players. You're hoping, again, that you can get back to that point where you have starting with offensive linemen, and then it just kind of works itself out from there. Not to say that the skill players, the quarterback position, the defense, and others aren't important, but trenches are I don't know if
you can't win without it.
No, exactly right. That's the best way to put it.
You can't win without it. I mean, and is it important to have great wide receivers or a solid quarterback or a good group of running backs? Absolutely. But you can have all these other pieces, and if you're missing, it's kind of like the corner piece in putting a puzzle together. My wife loves putting these big, like, 1,000, 2,000 piece puzzles together that take a week to do. Well, until you find the corners, it's hard to get the, you know, you start with the borders, right? You start with the corners and you build the border out. Well, that's your offensive line and your defensive lines in the SEC. Until you kind of figure that part out, you know, all the other pieces are just going to sit there on the kitchen table for a while. So you got to figure out the corners and the borders, and that's your line play.
Yeah, it's just, I mean, it's like you're saying, it starts with there. It starts with, again, just the, I don't know, the layer buildup. It's like when you build, it's like the old parable, the man that builds his house on the sand is doomed to fail, and the man that builds on his house on the rock is doomed to succeed. Well, Arkansas has built their house on basically a house of cards as of late. You need something to build your house on a sturdy position on. And again, that starts with the offensive line. It really starts from the head coach, and then moving on down, it goes from there.
Yeah. And it's about philosophy. It's about what's important. And we know that with Sam Pittman, line of scrimmage play is going to be a priority. And I just don't know, you know, since Sam Pittman left, they just never figured out the position coach that could really make it all come together. I mean, and it didn't seem to be a priority at all with Chad Morris and his crew. So we know Sam Pittman gets it. That's where it starts, is having a head coach
inside
that gets it.
Inside out, not outside in.
Exactly. NWA Gold and Silver, Bentonville, Fayetteville, and in Fort Smith. Right now, bring your gold or silver coins to NWA Gold and Silver. They'll tell you what it's worth. Maybe that old broken jewelry that you haven't worn in decades, stuff you've been given that you're never going to wear. Why don't you turn it into cash right now with NWA Gold and Silver? Gold is at a high price right now. So what you have in that jewelry box or that safety deposit box could be worth thousands of dollars. If you just want to find out what it's worth, bring it to NWA Gold and Silver. 1130 North Walton in Bentonville, Nelson's Crossing by Jason's Deli in Fayetteville, and on Rogers Avenue in Fort Smith. It's NWA Gold and Silver, Bentonville, Fayetteville, Fort Smith, the people that pay the most.
Richard Davenport joins us next.
If you have experience transporting frozen and refrigerated goods and want to be part of a trucking family with insurance and be home every week, you need to contact Brent Higgins Trucking. Since 1997, Brent Higgins Trucking in Mulberry has been proudly delivering to and from various areas of the United States, including but not limited to Oklahoma, Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi. Brent Higgins Trucking, where you're a name, not a number. Contact them at 479-997-2366 or at BrentHigginsTrucking.com.
Now is the perfect time to invest in your own backyard oasis. And Burton Pools and Spas has everything you need. Semi-in-ground pools starting at just $9,997. Hot tubs starting as low as $2,695. And that includes delivery, cover, and startup chemicals. And with 60 luxury spas in stock, you're sure to find the perfect one for you. Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
Are your appliances struggling? Do you need that part and not sure where to go? Mid-South Distributing has you covered with 9 locations in the Arkansas area. Appliance parts and accessories for all major brands of appliance. Mid-South Distributing has you, the customer, in mind when you are needing that part for your appliance. Mid-South Distributing. Check out MidSouthParts.com to find your location near you. Mid-South Distributing. We're in your neighborhood.
Tommy Kraft for the Fence Man. If you've always wanted powered automatic gates at your home or business, but you didn't know who to call, let me tell you about the Fence Man. 479-782-3936. The Fence Man does it all. Custom wrought iron installations, automatic gates, even controlled access systems, and lots more. Ask about 18-month, same-as-cash financing with approved credit. For your custom fence and gate needs, call the Fence Man. 479-782-3936. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. Have your travel plans changed? Looking for a place that's close to home and keep your family safe? Gaston's White River Resort is located on the beautiful White River. They offer private accommodations in their lodges and cabins. Most cabins have a fully equipped kitchen or let their restaurant staff deliver to your cabin. Call 870-431-5202 and change your plans to Gaston's White River Resort. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time. Every time.
Full-time farmers, hobby farmers, and landowners, your time is important. Make the most out of that time with a brand new Branson tractor from Bush Machine and Tractor in Fort Smith. With tractors from 19 to 105 horsepower, we have a tractor that will fit your needs. Ask Bush Machine and Tractor about their special financing options and free loader rebates. Bush Machine and Tractor in Fort Smith is Arkansas's number one Branson dealer. Check their inventory at bushtractor.com.
Hey sports fans, this is Scott from Calico County and wanted to let you know that we have reopened our dining room. Of course, we're doing all the things that the health department requires us to do with limited seating, distancing, and the other measures to keep you protected. During this time, we're continuing our curbside pickup. We also are still offering delivery through the Waiter app and DoorDash app, and also wanted to let you know that our catering is still available. So for breakfast, lunch, or dinner, it's Calico County just off Rogers Avenue behind Randall Ford.
For the month of June, Franco Furniture, stock full of Made in the USA. You heard right, Made in the USA furniture and Speed Queen washers and dryers all on sale. Franco Furniture wants you to know we are taking every precaution necessary to keep you safe. We will have hand sanitizer available along with masks. Franco Furniture's number one priority is keeping our customers safe. In-store, no credit check financing. Family owned and serviced after the sale for 27 years. Franco Furniture! 405 4th Street, Barling, Arkansas. Best seats in the house.
To feel the calming effects of nature, take a deep breath. In and out. Every breath makes you feel closer to nature. And every sip makes nature feel closer to you. Michelob Ultra Pure Gold. Beer in its organic form.
Things are really heating up at Rath Auto Resources. Hi folks, Larry Rath here with our biggest sale of the year, the Summer Sales Drive. It's the best time to save on a great inventory of Rath Road Ready vehicles. each one hand-picked and inspected in our Meineke Car Care Center to ensure you're buying the best pre-owned vehicle you'll find anywhere. And we're making it easy with $1,200 Rath Auto Relief to use as you choose on select inventory and summer savings on every car in stock. Like a 2018 Hyundai Elantra SEL, low miles and fully equipped, just $13,993, or payments as low as zero down and $219 a month while they last. If you're keeping the car you have, let us get it ready for summer in the Meineke Car Care Center with free AC checks, half-off brakes, and buy three, get one free on all tires. Summertime is fun time and the right time to save on a nicer, newer car during the summer sales drive at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources, and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online at rathauto.com.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
Ridge of high pressure builds in, locks in for the next few days. Looking at sunny skies, our high temperatures this afternoon mid-80s, mainly clear upper 50s tonight. And then tomorrow, lots of sunshine, a little bit warmer with our high in the upper 80s. We're right back to near 90 Saturday. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Hey, this is Matt Jenkins. Be sure to listen to Halftime weekdays from 12 to 2 on ESPN 95.3 and hitthatline.com.
You're listening to The Morning Rush live from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3, KERX Paris, Fort Smith. This hour of The Morning Rush is brought to you by Bud Light, brewed with the best barley, rice, water, and hops to be America's favorite light beer. Bud Light, please drink responsibly.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden, and you're listening to The Morning Rush.
Broadcasting live from the Bud Light Studio.
You're causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of lions, tigers, and bears, but they even one Razorback. Number one.
This is The Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
That's cool. I can dig it.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
Gonna talk some Arkansas recruiting coming up here with Richard Davenport in just a sec. Before we do that, it is a Recruiting Thursday, and it's brought to you by Breeden RV. They got their annual trade-up event going on right now through the end of June. Head over, get up to $5,000 off NADA trade-in value, and you can take advantage of rock bottom prices on new, used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. Trade up and get free maintenance for life on everything new. Plus, they're going to take care of your service needs on all makes and models, whatever you bring in. So go online right now to BreedenRV.com, check out their selection, or come see them between Van Buren and Alma off Alma Highway. Breeden RV, where adventures begin. Richard, you got some decent news this past week, man. Baseball, football, basketball, you're having to go over the place, but I want to start with Raheem Rocket Sanders. I know Arkansas fans are really excited about him. Coolest nickname I've heard and seen in a while. What can you tell us about Raheem Sanders, Richard?
Probably the coolest, like you said, coolest nickname since, I don't know, Batman maybe? I don't know, but he's 6'2", 210-pound receiver, safety, possibly linebacker. Arkansas is recruiting him as an athlete, but I tend to think he'll probably end up being a receiver at Arkansas. But had a top five of Arkansas, Oklahoma, Florida State, Missouri, and South Carolina before choosing the Hogs this week. And he was a guy that had a very impressive offer list. Thick kid who's got good speed, who kind of bounces off people when he catches the ball and starts to go to the house. But a very, very good pickup from the standpoint. He's from Florida. They're getting back into Florida with Coach Pittman and this staff, and I think they're in good shape with some other guys too in that state.
Richard, switching over to basketball. Now, this isn't a high school kid, but it is a grad transfer. Justin Smith out of Indiana commits to the Razorbacks. What do you think he brings to the table as far as Arkansas basketball is concerned?
I think he brings, obviously, maturity, brings athleticism. That's one thing that really stands out about him. A 48-inch vertical, which is insane.
Same as Jordan's, Richard. Same as Indiana.
Yeah. Yeah, I tell you what, you talk to people. I talked to Paul Benincardi and I talked to Van Coman. Both of these guys have been in the business for a long, long time, and both of them were really high on him. Van Coman, who's been covering basketball for 43 years, he thinks he's an NBA guy, you know, probably a journeyman type, but can definitely play in the league. So you're adding a guy with athleticism, versatility, not a great outside scorer. You know, he shot like 26% from the three, so he'll probably maybe pop one once in a while from three, but most of the damage he'll do offensively will be in the paint, putbacks from rebounds and driving to the basket. But and he's very good defensively, has the capability to guard several positions.
I want to go back to football for just a second and the relationships and how they're building them right now, and particularly with Sanders that we were talking about just a moment ago, Rocket Sanders. Was this a relationship as a holdover from Georgia and that staff and some of the guys that Sam Pittman's brought with him? Or because not being able to bring these guys on campus, you wonder how they're nurturing these relationships along other than Zoom right now. What can you tell us about the background between this staff and this particular recruit with Sanders?
Really not a long relationship. It was started when they got here, and they just gained his trust. And I think just being genuine with him and his mother, one of the things he told me was how he feels like that if he goes to Arkansas, that he's going to be taken care of, that they're going to be looking out for him. And that's something that seemed like it really resonated with him. He talked to Coach Pittman, talked to Coach Browse, Coach Stepp, Coach Fountain. He was kind of tag teamed a little, quite a bit as far as the recruiting process, and built a solid relationship with all those coaches. And he just felt extremely comfortable. And like you said, he hasn't visited Arkansas yet, but for them to be able to get that done without a visit is obviously very impressive. It's not unheard of. It does happen, but the majority of the cases are a kid has visited the campus, but obviously not the case with Rocket.
You mentioned getting back into Florida. I think about Alex Collins when I think about Florida recruits and in Bielema's early go here, getting Alex to come up. Who on this staff really is going to have the primary responsibility for working that part of the country?
With Justin Stepp, he recruits all the receivers, whether they're in Florida, Texas, wherever. He's going to recruit the guys at his position, and then you got several of the other assistants assigned to Florida. Scott Fountain, the special teams coach, he's got part of Florida. And looking at my list right now, what you're saying here, sorry. But then you got Sam Carter. He's got parts of Jacksonville. And then John Cooper's got Pensacola and Orlando. So you got about four or five coaches in Florida. Jimmy Smith's also in Florida. He's got Tampa all the way down to Miami. So they're gonna continue to recruit that state, and I think you're probably gonna see anywhere from two to three guys out of the state of Florida on a given, on average.
Yeah, and when you win a guy out of Florida and you win him over and he commits to Arkansas, you're gonna be going up against a lot of other SEC schools and all those places you just mentioned. So you're getting a recruit that's a three or a four star in a lot of cases that is choosing Arkansas over an Auburn, or choosing Arkansas over Florida, or some really good quality SEC programs more often than not.
And there's no doubt about that. And the quality of football that they play in Florida, because of the amount of athletes, a lot of these guys are, I'm not going to say that they're automatically SEC ready, but they're the odds of them coming in and just being blown away by the competition and the athleticism of college athletes is probably a little less than maybe, a state that doesn't have as good of high school football.
Talking with Richard Davenport on Recruiting Thursday here on The Morning Rush. Richard, so DVH has already scheduled out all four in-state schools. Mike Neighbors has done the same thing. As far as in-state baseball talent goes, how much is playing in-state schools going to help high school baseball talent within the state of Arkansas?
You know, I think it's like any sport to say if Arkansas plays other in-state programs, I think it creates more interest, kind of creates a buzz. I don't know, you know, it may get a kid who's kind of borderline on baseball to maybe give the sport a try, you know, especially if he thinks that maybe he could play on the next level, you know, and he's maybe marginal in the other sports. So I don't necessarily think it's going to be a huge deal, but I think it definitely helps. And, you know, I think it, you know, it just promotes the sport within the state.
We were talking about this a little earlier as far as Arkansas basketball is concerned. Richard, have you heard anything involving what's going on with Ethan Henderson right now?
Well, evidently there was a situation with him and his ex-girlfriend. I'm just going by what I just read, what Matt Jones posted on our message board. Evidently he and his ex-girlfriend got into an argument, and other than that, that's all I know. That's all I know, because I really haven't looked into it.
Yeah, I think, you know, people are – I've seen some reactions, and it's fan reaction. We know that the numbers with Musselman's roster right now are out of balance, and that he's got one more than the scholarship limit. I don't think it's safe to assume that, well, this automatically takes Henderson out of the equation. I think it's going to be interesting to see – A, how this situation plays out, how Musselman deals with a disciplinary issue, but also, or a potential disciplinary issue, we should say, but also, Richard, how he handles this situation where he's a plus one right now.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, I know fans always get a kind of in an uproar when things, you know, like this, when you're over a, you know, a scholarship, but technically, you know, we don't know what Isaiah Joe's going to do. I still think he's going to come back, but the numbers will always work themselves out. And let me say this about Ethan. I in the time that I covered Ethan, all I can say is he was always an impressive, just a considerate young man. Yes sir, no sir, just a great kid. So I don't know exactly what happened, but I would be surprised if anything bad came out of this situation. I really do. He's a really good kid.
Richard Davenport of the Arkansas Democrat Gazette. You can follow him on Twitter at @AR Recruiting Guy. Joins us every Thursday at 8 o'clock to talk a little recruiting. Richard, we appreciate it, man. You have yourself a good weekend, okay?
All right, guys. Take care.
Good stuff from Richard, as always.
Yeah. Hey, we're brought to you by Joe's Grill and Cantina, South 74th Street, across from Harps. Their dining room has been open for a couple of weeks now. If you've been missing Joe's, you can go and enjoy it there. With all the nice weather we've had, it's a great time to have lunch or dinner on the patio at Joe's Grill and Cantina. So get there or call and make a reservation. They are taking those. They're suggested, not required, but you can make a reservation at Joe's to make sure you have a table for you and your group when you head over. 479-478-9600. Joe's, the chips and the salsa are outstanding. We love the some of the family packs we've enjoyed during this time where, you know, you've done a lot of to-go. Their fajita family pack is awesome. The taco bar they have, they're still doing the family packs. If you prefer the to-go and the curbside, still got that. But just know that you're welcome in for all their menu and all their specials they got at Joe's. Just call and, you know, get a suggested reservation right now at Joe's Grill and Cantina. 478-9600. You'll love it at Joe's. You can read more online at joesfortsmith.com. That's Joe's Grill and Cantina, South 74th Street in Fort Smith, across from Harps.
86 days out from Arkansas football as we get closer to that. I know people are excited about that. I think when looking ahead, I mean, do you think that Arkansas fans are more excited about football season, basketball season, or next year's baseball team? Because I think, Tommy, when you look at those three sports, you got a new coach in football, you got what looks to be up and coming basketball team, and then baseball is going to be as talented as recruiting class you've ever had on the Hill.
I think people are just excited to have sports back in general. The the main stick and ball sports. We want to see anything right now. I know golf's returning this weekend. We've had NASCAR back. I think people just want some normalcy.
Where is it at this? Do you know where it's at this weekend? Golf?
Golf. I know the Colonial's coming up, but it's not this week. I do not know.
I was like to say, I couldn't tell you where it is either.
But, you know, but I'll watch because it's golf and it's real. It's the it is the Colonial. Yeah, it's the Colonial going to be down in Dallas. So, Fort Worth, actually. So,
that'll be this weekend. That's a hop and a skip over with an all because I'll be in the lake in Dallas this weekend. So, I guess I could go over there.
We'll have to. Yeah, I have to send you over there. You can be our correspondent this weekend.
I got a chance to, when this would have been two years ago, there was a, in Fort Worth, I don't know if it was the Colonial, but Austin, I'm forgetting his name, what's former golfer for the Razorbacks. Ring any bells? Austin Cook. Austin Cook.
Yeah, it's from Jonesboro.
My old roommate, that's his brother-in-law. So okay. We got a chance. We got free passes and stuff. Got to go down there. It was really fun. I was decked out in Razorback gear, obviously. Really excited to see him. But I believe, Tommy, that was my first PGA Tour event.
Mm-hmm.
And my roommate got hit by one of Jim Furyk's bad drives. So, and he ended up signing his glove and everything, which was pretty cool. I think it was Jim. Yeah, I'm 99% sure.
Did the guy have a loop in his backswing?
He was older and tall.
Jim Furyk. Okay, He's got a little bit of a hitch in his giddy up.
So it was pretty cool to see that. And I laughed because my roommate we're standing just on the side and he goes, ow! And I was like, what was that voice? And he's like, I just got hit by the golf ball. And so we're sitting next to it waiting for Furyk. And I hope this is who this is. I'm 99% sure it's Furyk. Furyk trots up. And it's like, hey, man, did I hit you? I'm sorry. And ends up signing his glove. And it was, I'm like, low key, Reese, I'm kind of glad you got hit because we wouldn't have this interaction if not for the case. So.
He's not really sorry that he hit you. He's just glad you were there, that your leg got in the way of his ball going further into the rough.
Yeah. So it was quite entertaining. But I think we've talked about bucket list stuff before, Ryder Cup's on that. But if you get a chance, and I think. Even the non-golf fans, I think someone's just, they need sports so bad, right? That people are going to turn on golf this weekend.
I mean, you asked the question, what are we most anxious for, Razorback football, basketball, or baseball? I think just if basketball season started tomorrow, we'd be excited for it. If we could resume baseball somehow, we'd be excited. I think, it's football because that's what's next up. So we're most excited about football. And there's probably more unknown about football than the other two sports, right? We know baseball is going to be really good. Mm-hmm. We know about the roster, and we can kind of put a, quote, depth chart together for basketball, even though you don't really have a depth chart. But we've been talking about starting lineups and positions, who's going to play what. We got a fairly good idea of how the basketball team will be constructed. Football? Not so much. We struggle. We talked about it earlier with Tom. A lot of returning starters on the offensive line, but how's that going to look? We know about Rakeem Boyd. We think Felipe Franks will be the starter at quarterback. We know about the wide receivers. There's a ton of question marks on the defensive side of the ball, a ton of them. And, how's Dorian Gerald going to look back after a year off with the artery strain in his neck?
AJ, you got so many different, whether they're incoming JUCO, incoming freshmen, incoming grad transfers. There's, like you said, a couple question marks.
Is there anything more unknown in Razorback sports right now than the Arkansas defense?
I don't know anything about the tennis teams and their third guy. But, no, as far as what we talk about on a daily basis within Arkansas men's basketball, men's football, and then baseball.
I'm just talking about how they've been so behind the curve in the SEC, how Barry Odom is going to be able to bring them along and all of how the personnel is going to look on deep. We talk a lot about offense, and we went through the names. We don't sit here and go through names. I mentioned Dorian Gerald and how he's going to – we don't sit here and go through names and rifle through them at the three levels of the defense quite the way we do on offense in particular. I think we probably need to spend more time talking about defense because, you can score all the points you want, but until you stop somebody, it's not going to matter a whole lot.
So if we – and I don't have a depth chart or anything in front of me, but if you look at the defensive line, the addition of Julian Coates out of JUCO, Dorian Gerald coming back, Some of the more you got Xavier Kelly
from Clemson,
like the incoming Clemson guy. Those are some notable defensive linemen. Blaine Toll was originally thought to be going there, but he looks like he's going to be playing the tight end position. Then the linebacker position, whether it's Bumper Poole, whether it's Grant Morgan, whether it's Levi Draper, those are some of the guys that definitely come to mind as far as the linebacker position goes. Then you move on to the secondary. Jalen Catalan, Devin Bush, the guy that was highly recruited, didn't play a lick last year. Other guys that stand out, Ladarius Bishop. I mean, there's just you've got questions, obviously, for those position groups.
That's the defense. Most time we've spent talking about personnel on defense in how long? You know, I mean, it's just where the conversation naturally steers back to the glamour positions on offense, quarterback, running back, wide receiver. But
and that's just off the top of my head.
Right. I mean, you know, that's the most time we've really spent talking about defensive personnel in a while. And I just think that's one of the things that I'm excited to see kind of play out and come together. I'm
trying to think if there's anyone else that is notable that I left off the list. Jerry Jacobs, incoming transfer from Arkansas State, would be another one as well. So those are some guys that I've just listed off, just literally kind of just word vomit off the top of my head that I can think of. But, yeah, defense is a big issue for this football team this year. I know that we talked about yesterday, Barry Odom ranked the fourth best defensive coordinator in the Southeastern Conference by Saturday Down South, Michael Braddon. But now he's going to have some issues with the talents around him. I know that you and I had a little joking back and forth. I thought I sold you on John Chavis wasn't the guy, but you made the point that, well, he didn't have any players. Well, Barry Odom's basically inheriting the same players. So, can Barry
Odom... How much better can he make the same group of guys?
One man's... And this is... I don't know if this is the right phrase. You always hear the one man's trash is another man's treasure. Not to... I mean, let's be honest. The defense was trash last year.
They played like
The individuals that make up the team. I'm not calling the players on that track. I'm talking about the unit.
Yep.
Was trash.
Just look at the numbers.
Look at the numbers. That's how it is. And they weren't that good the year before either. So that being said, you hope that Barry Odom can come in as the defensive coordinator. And we're going to be catching up with Barry Odom tomorrow at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. Real excited about that. You hope he can be the guy to come in and really pick up the offense and then get things going. Or excuse me, defense, get things going.
Hey, invest in your own backyard oasis with Burton Pools and Spas. Semi-in-ground pools right now are one of the hot items that Burton's is selling. Great price, but a great way to transform your backyard in a shorter amount of time. Semi-in-ground pools start at $9,997. So a great way to go with a great look. You can build some great decking, patios around it, and have an awesome look with a semi-in-ground pool. Hot tubs as low as $26.95, and that includes delivery cover and all the startup chemicals you need. In fact, over 60 luxury spas are in stock at Burton Pools and Spas. I love my Big Green Egg. If you're looking for the place to buy a Big Green Egg, any of the accessories, any of the great things that go along with making a green egg, the perfect cooking device in your backyard, they have it at Burton Pools and Spas. Look online, burtonpools.com. Or stop in Springdale or their Fort Smith location and see everything they have to offer. They do water testing this time of the year, so if you need someone to help you with the water in your pool and getting it perfectly balanced, Burton's can help you with that as well. It's Burton Pools and Spas, Springdale and in Fort Smith, your source for backyard fun.
Afternoon host Zach Arnes and I had a conversation yesterday, a little bet that we've kind of put together as far as the Notre Dame-Arkansas game goes. We'll get into that next. Stay with us. It's the Morning Rush.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
If you have experience transporting frozen and refrigerated goods and want to be part of a trucking family with insurance and be home every week, you need to contact Brent Higgins Trucking. Since 1997, Brent Higgins Trucking in Mulberry has been proudly delivering to and from various areas of the United States, including but not limited to Oklahoma, Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi. Brent Higgins Trucking, where you're a name, not a number. Contact them at 479-997-2366 or at BrentHigginsTrucking.com.
We're all in uncharted territory looking for ways to support our communities. At Dell Technologies, we're making sure small businesses have the right tech solutions. Dell Technologies advisors are here for you, from helping small businesses stay connected and productive while working remotely with Windows 10 and Microsoft Teams, to rapidly deploying remote work solutions that limit upfront costs with Dell Financial Services. We're standing by you every step of the way. Call 877-ASK-DELL. That's 877-ASK-DELL.
Foot odor throwing you off your game? Stick to a winning game plan with Odor Eaters, featuring three advanced odor and wetness fighters. The lineup provides long-lasting odor control plus more to keep your feet on their game.
Odor Eaters powder provides outstanding moisture control. Clear drying spray is the MVP in preventing athlete's foot, while insoles work continuously to manage wetness while adding a layer of comfort. Pick up today at Walmart, Target, CVS, Dollar General, or other fine retailers.
Odor Eaters. Destroy foot odor with the best in odor defense.
Your locally owned TGI Fridays in Fort Smith is now open for dine-in, curbside to-go, and delivery for both lunch and dinner, 7 days a week. TGI Fridays is taking your safety seriously, following every guideline. Enjoy Friday's favorites like appetizers, burgers, sandwiches, salads, all the great Fridays, signature entrees, kids' meals, and great desserts. TGI Fridays, now open for dine-in, curbside to-go, and delivery. Call 479-484-0906. That's 484-0906. Or order online at Fridays.com. Your locally owned TGI Fridays at I-540 and Rogers in Fort Smith.
Wave Rural Connect is bringing state-of-the-art fiber, internet, TV, and phone services right into your home. Get amazing fast fiber internet, 100 megabits for only $49.95 per month, or 1 gigabit for only $79.95 per month. TV packages from the basics to our amazing altered TV, starting at $32.95. Fiber phone services start at $29.95. Go to WaveRuralConnect.com to find out if we are installing in your area, or call 1-833-4-WAVE-RC. Arkansas Valley Electric Cooperative and Wave Rural Connect, changing the communities we sir.
Spring is here and there's no better time to get out of the house and back on the road. Time for the windows rolled down and the radios turned up. Southern Tire Mart proudly offers America's most trusted brands such as Toyo. Trust us for your last minute getaways, open road adventures, and memories that outlast the drive. When you can rely on your tires, you are free to enjoy the ride. Your Toyo tires are waiting for you at Southern Tire Mart, just off I-540 at exit 14 in Fort Smith. Southern Tire Mart and Toyo, we keep you rolling.
Have you been looking for your next place to call home and just haven't found the right one? Then it's time to check out the properties at Trinity Multifamily. With a variety of apartments, duplexes, townhomes, and houses, there is surely one to fit your needs. Whether it's in the River Valley, Northwest Arkansas, or Central Arkansas that you are looking at, they have you covered. Give them a call today. Trinity Multifamily, 479-452-1817. That's 479-452-1817. Or online at trinitymultifamily.com to search rental properties near you.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC has over 200 pre-owned vehicles to choose from luxury to economy and everything in between, including over 50 great vehicles with payments under $250 a month, certain to fit your needs and your budget. And at Harry Robinson Buick GMC, you always get more for your trade. 50 vehicles with payments under $250 a month at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off I-540 in Fort Smith.
Tri-Hill Turf offers the highest quality turf and pest services. Hey, you say those are big words. Well, let's see. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has a company agronomist, state and nationally certified technicians, free soil testing, and they even have precision GPS guided application equipment. Now that's high tech. For over 30 years, Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has used the latest application technology, and they strive for turf and pest excellence. They are your local turf and pest experts. Call the local team at 782-0404. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest.
It's time for the annual trade-up event at Breeden RV, going on through June 30th. Trade up and get up to $5,000 on NADA trade-in value. Take advantage of rock-bottom prices on all new and used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. Head to Breeden RV's trade-up event and get free maintenance for life on everything new. Breeden RV will also take care of your service needs on all makes and models. Shop today at BreedenRV.com, then come see Breeden RV between Van Buren and Alma on Alma Highway. Breeden RV, where adventures begin. See dealer for details.
Some of my fondest childhood memories are from volunteering with my grandmother. Helping others was her passion. She'd always say, "The sweetest fruits of life come from serving others." And she was right.
At Shelter Insurance, we strive to make a positive impact in the communities where we work and live.
Ask Wade Gilkey in Fort Smith or Jim Malum in Charleston about Shelter's home insurance.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Craig.
When my time comes, I want to be buried face down so that anyone who doesn't like me can kiss my ass.
Streaming live at hitthatline.com.
I want to talk about Zach Arnes and I's bet concerning the Notre Dame-Arkansas game in South Bend that's coming up. And before we do that, we're telling you about Breeden RV because it is their annual trade-up event going on right now through the end of June. Take advantage of up to $5,000 over NADA trade-in value. And you can take advantage also of the rock-bottom prices on new and used travel trailers, fifth wheels, and motorhomes. You get free maintenance for life there on everything new at Breeden RV. Plus, they'll take care of your service needs too. Ransom and the gang can do it all. So come by and see them today at Breeden RV off Alma Highway or check them out online at BreedenRV.com. Breeden RV, where adventures begin. So Zach Arnes called me yesterday. I did not call him. Want to get that on the record to begin with. He called me because I made the joke. I can't remember who said something on social media, but I made the joke. Arkansas is going to go down to South Bend and beat Notre Dame. Completely being facetious. Completely being sarcastic. Mm-hmm. And Zach Arnes took offense to that. Not 2 minutes later did I get a call from Mr. Arnes talking about this particular subject. And the first thing that popped out of his mouth is, what's the bet? I'm just like, okay, a bet. He's like, what's the bet? I was like, Zach, you know I don't actually think that Arkansas is going to go down to Notre Dame. I've said that since.
So let me just be clear. I don't want to misquote you. So everything you say on Twitter is not the truth? I just want to be clear about what you're saying here.
You can be sarcastic, can you not?
Well, I mean, there's a difference between sarcasm and then just flat mistruths. So what you say on Twitter, I need to take a salt shaker
well,
to
you don't
all
take
your
me,
tweets.
You don't take me seriously in anything.
I just wanted
say.
To be clear about what we're talking about here.
You would have to dig up that rabbit hole. I don't know
I'm
how
just
to
doing you the way you would do me.
I don't know how to adequately answer that.
He would
that.
Never do you
no.
like that.
How do I adequately answer that? I had an emoji on there, the woozy emoji that typically means
the
like
what emoji?
The woozy emoji, which is like a crazy emoji. So
okay.
Insinuating right. I was kidding. So that's all the right. best way I can answer.
She stamped it with sarcasm.
Yeah, stamped it with
gotcha.
Sarcasm. So gotcha. And I tagged Arnes in as well. And so Arnes called me.
I just wanted to know if you're believable or not. That's all I was trying to get to.
Most, if not all the time.
Jenkins is enjoying this.
Listen, if I said I told the truth all the time, then we all know that I would be.
Yeah, but anytime we want to have some liberties with the truth at your expense, you are quick to correct the record.
Yeah,
you are
exactly.
very quick. Oh, no. You want to check my text? You want to look at my birth certificate? You want to take my, you just keep going, you know.
Listen.
I just want to check the record.
Don't
here,
let
you know?
Don't let the facts get in the way of a good story.
Unless it's at your expense.
So Arnes and I have agreed on the point spread Friday night before the Notre Dame-Arkansas game, which takes place September the 12th in South Bend, Indiana. And the loser of this, we're going to have to, Tommy brought up a good point to me before the show, that we're going to have to kind of renegotiate the bet because the original bet was the loser has to stand in opposing gear. I would be wearing Notre Dame stuff because that's where Arnes went to school. I don't think he graduated because he's not that smart. But Arnes went to school at Notre Dame, and I went to school.
Or was he like Rudy the first couple? He went to St. Mary's or whatever it is across the street.
Honestly, he probably went to Holy Cross.
Holy Cross, and said
he went to Notre Dame.
Thank
that would
you.
Be the most Zach Arnes thing ever. So,
and he painted the helmets on Thursday night.
The line I checked is around like 28 points right now. I'm hoping that sucker gets up to like 35 or something. But we decided it's like I lost the bet should be on the sign, but I'm thinking we should renegotiate that as well. And we also should renegotiate that during the duration of our show from 6 to 9, if Arnes were to lose the bet, he would have to be on Rogers Avenue, I-540,
well,
that we said.
That's fine. I don't really care. We just want to make it painful on him to have, because Zach doesn't know that 7 o'clock happens twice a day. He's always, you know, he sleeps till noon. He doesn't get up and go to work till noon.
He's a bum.
So, I mean, I just would, you know, let's make it as painful on him as possible that he would have to get up at 4:30 in the morning to be on his post to panhandle at 0600. Because the show begins at 0600, Zach. You got to be on your post to panhandle then. So we need him leaving his house at 4:30 in the morning.
And I think if Arkansas were to somehow miraculously win that game, Arnes should have to be in a Speedo and a Speedo only.
If they just went straight up?
Yeah, that would be the addition
too. I don't think that is fair to those that would be passing by.
It'd be
he's
a show.
Lost, who is he's lost some weight.
Yeah. You're welcome if you want to go look at Orange and Speedo.
I thought he was the most eligible bachelor that lives in Springdale, Arkansas.
Self-proclaimed, yes. That's okay. What he proclaims.
Yeah. So, but there needs to be, if Arkansas were to win that game, I would need to get something additional on top of what he would have to go through.
You want a little kicker?
Yeah, kicker. I think that's fair.
Yeah.
So.
For a straight-up win? Because there isn't any surprise if Notre Dame wins straight up. Yeah. That's obviously why there's a 28.5-point line right now.
So, but if they're able to keep it within 10, I mean, that'd be a surprise.
No, that's close is only I would win the bet because they would cover, right, which I'm counting on. But
yeah, this isn't horseshoes or grenades.
This would be in addition to, so I would want, if Arkansas again, which neither anyone in this room, hopefully no one listening, thinks that's going to happen, but I would want something additional, something so painful and so emotionally scarring that Zach Arns would not be able to do the show later that afternoon.
Well, that will be interesting. I just hope there is a game. I just hope Arkansas and Notre Dame actually play.
If they don't, they're scared.
Oh.
Is that it?
If Notre Dame doesn't play Arkansas, they're scared. That's what it comes down to. Nothing outside.
Not
just
a governor's decree. Nope. Not an order about COVID-19.
They're scared.
Just scared. Okay. I just hope the games are played.
See, that's are you picking up my sarcasm?
I think that's true. Okay. Coming out of your voice, sir. Hey, the Kevin Hickey Law Partner is there to help you with divorce, child custody issues, or criminal matters that you may be facing. Maybe you and DHS are having some problems when it comes to a family matter and you need some help. Kevin has dealt with DHS for years and can help you. With locations in Fort Smith and in Bentonville, for you to visit with Kevin, they'd love for you to make an appointment today. If you need help and an aggressive attorney fighting for you, from your corner, it's Kevin Hickey. Find him online at kevinhickeylaw.com. That's kevinhickeylaw.com.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
Hi, I'm Bill Bolton of NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins. I started this business in 1972 at an auction house that specialized in antique and estate jewelry, sterling silver, and coins. In that time, I've seen gold go from $35 an ounce to today's price of $1,683. I want to talk to you about the coins you may have inherited and how important it is to deal with someone who understands coins and this market. In 2011, we had a mother and daughter come into our store and sell us a lot of jewelry they no longer wore for $3,300. The daughter then pulled out an 1850 California $10 gold piece. Jeremy offered her $900, and she accepted his offer. He then advised her to have this coin graded. She did, and she sold it for $36,000. If you don't know what you have, please come see Jeremy in our Bentonville store. Don't sell it at an auction or an estate sale and get less money. What's in your safety deposit box could be worth thousands. NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins, Bentonville, Fayetteville.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC has over 200 pre-owned vehicles to choose from luxury to economy and everything in between, including over 50 great vehicles with payments under $250 a month, certain to fit your needs and your budget. And at Harry Robinson Buick GMC, you always get more for your trade. 50 vehicles with payments under $250 a month at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off I-540 in Fort Smith.
You have work to do. You need a tractor that helps get it done. TYM has the full range of tractors designed to meet the task. With the TYM easy-to-use controls and features, switching from one job to another is easy. And with the full range of models from 19 horsepower to 105 horsepower turbo, there is a TYM tractor that's right for the job and for you. But you can't buy a TYM tractor just anywhere. It's only sold at authorized TYM dealers like Bush Tractor, 7301 South Zero, Fort Smith.
Doe's Eat Place is now open to serve you the award-winning steaks you've been missing, along with your choice of drinks from the largest selection of wines, beer, and liquor in the River Valley. Doe's Eat Place is open Tuesday through Thursday, 5 till 9, and Friday and Saturday, 5 till 10. Doe's Eat Place welcomes their loyal diners back and new diners to experience the best steaks, atmosphere, and service in the River Valley. The patio is also open for your dining pleasure. Just call for reservations. Doe's Eat Place, 422 North 3rd Street, Fort Smith.
Hi, this is Melissa with True Grit Running Company. It's a difficult time right now, and social distancing is vitally important. That's why I'm here to encourage you to keep running. It's a great way to exercise in solitude, build up your immune system, and keep from going stir crazy. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram for more tips on how to take care of yourself during this time. And remember, just keep running. This has been brought to you by True Grit Running Company, 6808 Rogers Avenue, Suite B, behind Chick-fil-A.
Father's Day, June 21st, the day we honor those special dads. And Jelco Outdoors has store-wide savings on great gift ideas. 25% off Carhartt Force shorts and shirts. 25% off Timberland base plate shirts. 25% off all hunting clothing. 25% off all wallets. Save up to $400 on Browning gun safes, Sanuk sandals, 25% off. And many more gift ideas throughout the store. And Jelco gift cards are always the perfect fit. Jelco Outdoors, your Father's Day gift headquarters.
Hey, grounds guys.
Hey, what?
It's time to turn over my lawn maintenance to the professionals. My husband just hasn't had time to take care of our yard anymore, and I'm constantly on the go. But I don't want to leave my yard to just anybody. The grounds guys are a professional lawn care provider I know I can trust to keep my yard looking beautiful. They have different maintenance plans available to fit exactly what I need. For $100 off any annual maintenance plan, call the grounds guys today at 479-303-GUYS. That's 303-4897.
River City Bistro is open for lunch and dinner 7 days a week. River City's dining room is set up for your safety and comfort, or enjoy outdoor dining on the spacious patio. River City Bistro, locally owned and open Monday through Friday, 11 to 8. Weekends, 10 till 8 for brunch and dinner. Want River City curbside to go? Search on Facebook or Instagram for River City Bistro and order right from the page or on the website at rcbistro.com. River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
Are you a stress eater?
No, I've pretty much been an eater for a long time.
Subscribe to the Morning Rush podcast wherever podcasts are found.
See, hearing Sam Pittman talk about being an eater for quite some time, and I know a lot of the football coaches like to go over to CJ's Butcher Boy Burgers. Great location in Fayetteville. Also, the original location in Russellville. Exit 81 in Russellville, Arkansas Avenue, and then on the Weddington exit in Fayetteville. Here's what you do. Go to CJ's, get the 2/3-pound burger, get fries, and get a strawberry milkshake. And even if you're a chocolate fan, even if you're a vanilla fan, both are fantastic. My brother, get this, Tommy. So it's Father's Day next weekend, right?
Right.
My brother, instead of going, oh, well, he's coming down to Little Rock, I think. But first, he's got a pit stop because one of his buddies are getting engaged next weekend. And first thing that he said he's going to, he texted me about it because he saw Keith post this on Twitter. He's stopping at CJ's because Keith posted like 4 or 5 patties on this one burger.
I saw that.
And he's like, yeah, I'm going to get that. So I think my brother.
Do you think you could eat one of those?
No, 100%. If Keith wanted to have
I saw him struggle with the 2 patties. I mean, and then he's saying 4 or 5.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
It would be cake. If Keith wanted to do a burger challenge at either CJ's location, I would be down for it. Like 100%.
What kind of challenge? You did whip a barbecue platter. Pretty
I
well.
Did, yeah. So just been
in 30 Keith, minutes.
Time and place, Keith. That's what I'm saying. Two great locations. You can
maybe seen Keith today. I'll bring this up.
Go stop by. Go talk to him. Tommy's going to the Fayetteville location where you can take advantage of online ordering. You can order on the app. They also have a drive-through, and you can get it curbside pickup. And then the Russellville location, it's takeout, so you can call in from there. CJ's Butcher Boy Burgers. When all you do is burgers, they have to be the best. Hadn't heard from this guy in a while. Robbie is in San Diego. Robbie, what's going on, man? How are you this morning?
What's going on, boys? How's everything going?
It's good, but I'm sure it's not as good as San Diego.
Well, no, he can't do anything. He's in Cali. He's restricted by everything going on.
Is he in phase one?
No, we're actually in phase 3 in San Diego. Bars open up, I think, tomorrow. Restaurants opened up at about, 25-30% capacity. Gyms open Monday. It's all kind of coming back.
Well, that's about where we're at.
But it's still San Diego. It's 70 degrees year round, so not bad.
Yeah, you suck.
Hey, guys. So,
you suck.
I know. Hey, so at the end of the day, you know, I think yesterday was probably one of the greatest days in Razorback baseball history, because if you look at it, having a guy go number two overall screams volumes for our program. Not only that, but the things that Heston Kjerstad had to say after he got drafted, you know, talking about Dave Van Horn and the Arkansas program, that's like recruiting on steroids without having to spend a single dollar. So, I mean, it's to have that kind of exposure and to have a kid coming from, you know, out of state to come to Arkansas to play and have the success that he had, I think it just opens up a pipeline for even greater recruiting for West Texas, Texas overall. And it's going to make kids want to come to Fayetteville even more so as they want to right now. Van Horn's got a great problem right now. He's got too many players. He's got to figure out the roster. I think Arkansas baseball is in great shape. So we'll see what happens with day two. I think Casey Martin will get drafted at some point. But it's kind of a disappointment for him, considering that if you look before January, it was around January 2019, a lot of the MLB projections had him going number one overall for the 2020 draft. I think he's just going to have to figure it out in pro ball, how to hit a curveball and, you know, how to cut down some of those errors. And I think he's got the talent to play Major League Baseball, you know, every day. But it's just, you know, you just got to see what happens. What are your thoughts?
I remember seeing, I don't remember if it was D1 Baseball, by the way, Robbie, appreciate the call. So I remember, I think it was D1 Baseball, Tommy, that at one point, as Robbie mentioned, had Casey Martin as the number one prospect in the 2020 class. Unfortunately, he's not going to be drafted. He wasn't drafted in the first round last night. But as Robbie mentioned, if the guy starts hitting the curveball like we saw him do his freshman year, if the guy kind of slows down the errors a little bit and kind of lets those go by the wayside, he's going to have a successful career at the next level.
I think so, and I agree with Robbie that he does get his name called before five rounds are complete. Is he at a point where, I mean, obviously you take him back, because I think he'd be one of your best players if you got him back, but we know how good the SEC is, and those pitchers have those scouting reports. But would another year here at Arkansas get him past problems with a breaking ball and make him a first-rounder? Would he rather come back and play a year at Arkansas or be a fourth- or fifth-rounder right now?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, we again have seen the climb of Kjerstad and other players in their draft status. Would he be better off even in the fourth or fifth round coming back and being a first rounder? Or is there just too much risk with that?
I think there's too much risk compared to where he was slated originally, not out of high school, but where he was, and then to where he's gone. That's my opinion. I don't know what Casey's thoughts are on that. But that's my opinion.
I think there's like a 0% chance he's a Razorback again.
Yeah, no, I agree. All right, let's get into it. It is a Trivia Thursday. Jenkins has got some good questions lined up for this edition.
The toughest question.
What is going on?
The easiest answer.
Trivia! Trivia!
Pick your category.
Light on medical knowledge, heavy on Broadway trivia?
Ty or Tommy?
Fight!
It's time for Trivia Thursday.
Last week, we did fast food trivia, and much to my chagrin, I ended up losing because
you
forgot.
You thought you had me boxed in.
I did. Tommy's been on the road for 20-plus years doing sales, so I forget that he's been to every fast food establishment on the face of the earth.
It was pretty well a beatdown last week.
It wasn't as long as, you know, he smoked you last week.
It was bad. We can end it now.
No. 13 to 5, I think, was the final.
All right, let's not get out of hand.
I think we gave him one to get to 5.
Let's not get out of hand. Tommy's up 3-2 in our competition.
You always want to talk truth. I just wanted to speak.
13 to 5 was not the
Let the facts stand in the way of a good story.
I think it was 13 to 5.
Jenkins, just get this edition going.
All right, so gentlemen, high and tight in your chairs. We've got
what is the topic?
This is MLB baseball food trivia.
Ooh.
So this is food that's available in concession stands across Major League Baseball towns. So I'm going to read
this,
you.
This was the one you picked? Do you have some knowledge here?
I don't, but we just had the MLB draft.
What's going to happen? I'm going to read you a description of a food item at the concession stand. You tell me the team that it is associated with. Make sense?
Let's go.
All right. The food is called the closer. The closer is not for the faint of heart. It's a triple-decker grilled cheese sandwich stuffed with 9 different cheeses and adorned with candied bacon. Excuse me. Can you get this at the Pittsburgh Pirates, St. Louis Cardinals, or the Philadelphia Phillies?
I'm going to go Pittsburgh Pirates.
That would be correct.
I was going
to
say.
Because I know it's in I've been to St. Louis. I've never been to Pittsburgh. I was thinking you're going to tell me Milwaukee because they're known for cheese. You just said Milwaukee, I'd have jumped all over that.
The Scoop Banana Split.
Ooh.
The powers that be in this stadium decided that the mini helmet full of soft serve wasn't good enough for their fans. Instead, they chose to offer a full-size batting helmet filled with 12 scoops of ice cream, several bananas, whipped cream, strawberry sauce, chocolate drizzle, and cherries in what has to be the biggest confectionery treat in the Major League Baseball. Can you get this at Seattle, the Chicago White Sox, or the Cincinnati Reds?
Cincinnati Reds.
That is incorrect.
White Sox?
White Sox is correct.
All right.
This next one is called the Bacon Flight. We've got barbecue spice, brown sugar glazed, black pepper, and jalapeno.
Oh.
You can order a flight of bacon at this stadium. Thick sticks of flavored goodness that'll elevate your spirits even as the opposing team raises a score. Can you get this at the Chicago Cubs, Chicago White Sox, or the Atlanta Braves?
Braves.
Incorrect.
Cubs.
Incorrect. White Sox.
I didn't think White Sox would. I went because I didn't think White Sox would be the answer twice.
Well, they got two things that I
want
to get
so now
there.
I want to. Do we brave? Would you brave to go to that side of Chicago to a White Sox game to get a flight of bacon and a batting helmet full of ice cream?
Yes, I will. Chicken and a waffle cone. Mm. At this stadium, you can get a waffle cone filled with mashed potatoes, topped with fried chicken nuggets, and drizzled with honey mustard. How are your boys' stomachs doing right now?
Growling.
Can you get this at the Texas Rangers, Houston Astros, or the KC Royals?
Houston Astros.
That is correct, yeah. Tommy.
That's a good guess.
The Mac Bat.
Ooh.
If you're taking it in a game here, you can grab one of these cones filled with macaroni and cheese, topped with your choice of chili, bacon, or tomatoes. Nobody's going to blame you for ordering one of each. Can you get this at Tampa Bay, the Miami Marlins, or the New York Mets?
We'll go Tampa Bay.
Tampa Bay is correct.
That's a great guess.
It's a great guess. You're up 3-1. The Murphadilla. This is a shredded cheese with pico.
Philadelphia.
No, that's not one of the choices.
Oh.
Shredded cheese, pico de gallo, beef brisket, and more fitted into a 24-inch quesadilla and laid to rest on a bed of Doritos.
Oh,
can you get this at the LA Angels, Arizona Diamondbacks, or the Texas Rangers?
Diamondbacks?
Diamondbacks is incorrect. You want
Texas Rangers.
Texas Rangers is correct.
It's correct. Oh, well. A 24-inch quesadilla.
That's a big one.
With brisket.
Yep.
And I get Doritos.
On a bed of Doritos. When it's laid to rest.
When do the Rangers open? I'm there opening day.
We need to be there for that. The Churro Dog. This decadent treat is available at the concession stands during this team's games. It's a churro inside of a donut topped with ice cream and chocolate sauce. The Arizona Diamondbacks, St. Louis Cardinals, or the Minnesota Twins?
Twins.
Incorrect.
What was St. Louis and who else?
Arizona.
Arizona.
Arizona's correct.
It's hot. It's ice. You need ice cream. Even though it's an indoor stadium. I've been to that stadium.
Tommy, you know what the score is?
5-1. I didn't hear you. What is that?
5-1.
Okay. Go
ahead. Did you hear it that time?
Yeah.
Okay. The D-Bat Dog, an 18-inch long corn dog stuffed with jalapenos, cheddar, and most importantly,
sounds like a state
bacon.
Fair. Sounds like a
and
state
you can
fair.
Get the D-Bat Dog anywhere at the Arizona Diamondback Stadium, Kansas City Royals, or the Miami Marlins.
I don't remember that being at Kauffman, but
I don't either.
Ty, you need to get something here.
Kauffman Stadium, Kansas City.
That is incorrect.
I don't remember.
Boss man?
Arizona.
That is correct.
God. Just a massacre.
What just happened to you, Ty?
I don't know.
You mouthwatered when I said mac and cheese earlier, so here's another one. This is called the Stoogies Mac and Cheese Dog. At this stadium, the mac and cheese dog is definitely a decadent. It is a sausage split down the middle, piled high with macaroni and cheese and lump crab meat, and dusted with Old Bay seasoning.
Ooh.
Can you get this at Yankee Stadium, the Boston Red Sox, or the Pittsburgh Pirates?
Yankee.
Incorrect.
Boston.
Incorrect. Pittsburgh. Oh,
Pittsburgh. Interesting.
I said Boston because of the crab meat, you know?
I wonder if Phil would actually know these delectable items if they're Pittsburgh related. Or
I'm going to bring this up later. I'm going to keep hold of this because he'll know these, I'm sure. Brunch Bloody Mary. Only available during day games, the Brunch Bloody Mary is a portable breakfast. It's a regular Bloody Mary that comes with sausage, egg, chicken, and waffles, donuts, and a bacon on a skewer.
Wow.
All that you're missing is some aspirin and maybe some Tums.
Are you a Bloody Mary guy?
No, I'm not really a
okay,
Bloody Mary.
I feel like that's
not
the most
tomato juice.
That's
guy.
The most controversial alcoholic drink out there.
I'll drink one, but it's not my favorite.
Can you get this at Tampa Bay or Miami or the Arkansas Travelers?
Miami.
Miami's incorrect.
God.
Tampa Bay.
Tampa Bay is correct. Last one. toasted grasshoppers.
Got to be KBO League.
Actually, it's not. It's in Major League Baseball. To be precise, this Mexican treat is exactly what it sounds like. A bunch of grasshoppers cooked and then dusted with chili lime salt for a crunchy snack that is also high in protein. Can you get this at the Seattle Mariners, Atlanta Braves, or the Houston Astros?
It's killed the appetite right here.
You want me to do another one?
No. I want to know where you're
smoking, Ty, right now.
Yeah, what is it? What are this?
Seattle, Atlanta, or Houston?
Atlanta.
Incorrect.
I want to say Houston because you said it was a
man.
It was a Mexican delicacy,
right?
But my gut says to say Seattle, so I'm going to go with Seattle.
Your gut is always correct. Seattle.
Seattle.
Last one. We'll save that
it's
for another
8
day.
8-1. Wow, just an absolute abysmal performance.
He's flexing on him.
For Tommy Kraft and Matt Jenkins, I got some studying to do. We'll talk tomorrow.
The Arkansas Scholarship Lottery has some much-needed good news to share. Every day, we're creating winning futures with lottery scholarships and winning moments for players from all over the natural state. We thank our players and we congratulate our scholars for helping us keep that winning feeling even in these challenging times. The lottery is here for students today and will be when it's time.